go for the double push out of C, but they could do that because the Omen still has From the Shadow. So then you're originally they're thinking, okay, if we get no contact, we plant the Operator far forward, and then From the Shadows is still available. But you hear the Showstopper, immediately you launch it, and then Povy not able to get the second blast back right away really slows things down. Everyone on the side of RQ, their crosshairs just have to be trained forward. And they're able to get to a scoreline that they don't mind after that rough 5-1 scoreline start.
Very, very much favorable. SRQ now swaps on over to the attack, where they perhaps might be able to dictate the pace a little bit better. So what I would want to see from Global Esports is some more active moments on their defensive side. Because what we've seen so far, RQ just very much so reacting to it. But then towards the end, they started to get some good reads onto how Global Esports moves.
For sure. I would love to see Global Esports get just as proactive, if not more, on this defensive side as well. Xfero's oftentimes left on an island for that lurk, for that information in between B and A main. So if you're able to target him, if you're able to take him out fast, or at least push him out of his comfort zone, that's going to be good news. But let's say, you know, an Operator comes out, an Outlaw comes out, something like that. We've seen Xfero's shots. He could be racking up the frags on the scoreboard real quick.
So still both teams needing to find these rounds, and it all starts once again with the pistol.
Oh, okay. So Toxic screen for B and C, just ditching rubble control entirely. You're just looking to fight this from the get-go. You want to flood it, you want to fill it, and just hold on to it. That's the plan from Global Esports.
You got the C's, you got the paint shells, why not? Russ tossing in for info. Instantly spotted out though, so now they're gonna have to be very cautious. But look at the movements, actually. RRQ coming in to take down Pillar.
Just gonna be that quick clear. Doesn't get tagged, so they might think that this is empty, but surely they're just vying for information on the util.
Wait, triple peek?
But flips, he hears the footsteps, he's looking for one.
Oh no!
He gets distracted by too much noise, and now you know that there's multiple people. You have to go see, but there's, I mean, everything's set up here. Killjoy and Viper.
Really quick. Benkai, very aware of this, just backs up completely. They know they have the numbers advantage, so trying to set up for the retake perhaps instead. Dark cover just to block out the exits,
and look at
waiting
the
for the spike plant.
They're waiting for that lurk as well. They know that the only thing that RQ can do is go for that lurk.
How long can they wait for, Will? Benkai's watching the exits. He picks up a quick double. 2GE now tries to take him down. Russ goes back in for the trade. Xfero now, the lurk taking a little bit far too long. The whole trio of Global Esports peeks out at the same time.
Yeah, I mean, it's a rough spot for RQ, right? You try to rush into C, you realize everything's set up there, and you know, okay, backup's probably arrived, we gotta go for the lurk. But since you know you can't wait, you're trying to push even deeper, trying to pinch them into Waterfall. Overall, I mean, listen, you're making deal with what you got, but they just don't clear this corner fast enough, and Bankai's able to get a crucial double kill. And after that, it's like, oh yeah, remember we were still waiting for Xfero? That lurk comes in just in time.
Fantastic, and this is a Global Esports that has now won both pistols on this map.
Nature's healing.
This improvement, exactly.
GE's winning pistols again. DRX is back on top. I mean, APAC is healing. Pacific is healing.
All it took was just a bit of time off, I suppose, from kickoffs.
All it took was Benji Fishy yelling at Magnet, and then everything corrected itself. Okay.
And also, just a lot of, you know, talking to coaches and paper-thin inside of lifts. But anyway, Poison Cloud back up on top now, and Global Esports firing some blank shots, able to take down 2GE.
Snake bites being drawn out. Still one in the chamber, though.
It's just tough. RQ just wanting to continue to dive through this, but oh, even Timmy the turret gets a little kill.
Yeah. I mean, it's an eco. You knew that you had already kind of hedged your bets here after you saw that first snake bite come in, so they're just trying to use the turret as a shield to cross in, cause some chaos since you didn't see the early, you know, stack on Killjoy utility. Well, you'll have to let that round go. Now with the half armors, what can they do? Thankfully, no outlaw on the other side of Global Esports. I haven't seen that come out just yet on this map.
Not quite. They do have a guardian, though. The main thing so far is just the fact that Global Esports have been making these rounds pretty darn flawless. RQ without any clear plans as to how they might be able to take advantage of the little rounds they get. There's a pretty big round deficit right now.
Yeah, look at the setup from Global Esports on the C side, right? If you are to go in there without the paint shells, I mean, you're going to be taking a lot of damage, and also you're going to be wasting a lot of time.
Oh.
Big clear.
Actually going through the door. Benkai tries to peek out, but has to be careful. He does not have the range with the Spectre.
Okay, so you just got a kill on to B. You've told them that you're trying to pressure the middle of the map. I would love to see RRQ try to get a reaction out of the A side as well. Just something else to see what the reactionary movement was from Global Esports.
Cover going Blitz out. Is trying to watch for that angle. Baited out a bit of a smoke from Lightning Fast.
Yeah, but I love that they push into this because you know that Omen was far out, right? He wasn't by rubble. He was already on his way back and out. So you got to imagine that this one way is just to buy time. It's a good clear with the Prowler as well.
What RRQ has to watch out for now, though, is also the little door.
Yeah, it's a setup here. It could be a trap setup for Blaziken, and they don't like what they're sniffing. They're just drawing attention. They know what they've done to Global Esports. They know they put the pressure down.
Rotations.
Yeah, the nano swarms. That's my big concern.
Nah.
Yeah, I mean, you have your paint shells. RRQ, they generally have thrown it far in whenever they needed
to.
But it goes a little too far deep. He lands right onto the first set. 15 seconds left.
That's going to take a little bit off the clock. Benkai trying to stall as long as he possibly can, but unfortunately not quite enough.
Big kill from 2GE. As soon as you hear that turret, ready for it, doesn't want to stop the plant.
Great TP up on top. There. Couple of wall banks trying to go through, but unfortunately...
Oh, what? I hit the earlier
one. He just slices aim all to the left.
Yeah, I mean, he doesn't know he hit the first one, but he did, and he lands the second as well. That's the Guardian for you.
That's how he checks. Okay. RRQ, though, still relatively healthy. They've got four guns in this fight. Dark Carver sets up, and 2G stays completely shrouded and hiding back. Blaziken continuing to try to fire through, but unfortunately, the timer is ticking, and he's running out of time. It's going to be RRQ walking away. Pros don't look at the explosions. We've got this round.
Yeah, everyone gets out safely as well. Like you said, Blaziken just going to die to the spike without too much weaponry in his hand. Going to get that third round of the second half, their first buy round, and not too much damage in terms of weaponry. Obviously, everyone losing their armor, etc. It's still going to be some creds that they'll have to reinvest.
But that said, I mean, this is a really tricky round that I think, like you mentioned at the start of this matchup, right? RRQ taking quite a bit of time just to clear out everything sometimes, and it comes down to the last 30 seconds. We were very worried that those nano swarms might not allow them to get the spike down.
Yeah, I mean, the paint shell's clearing at least the deeper one. That was a deal breaker, in my opinion. And now seeing if there's an adjustment from GE, see if there's a trap set up on C. They're going for the fast push, and look at the map. Xpharo and Flips are waiting for the counter push out. If GE has been studying the tape, surely a stack push comes out, and Flips is ready for it. As long as he lives,
wow.
RRQ, their plan is working. I think he's been heard, though, in B main as well by Pillars.
Not too bad. So even though he has made his position known.
So here's the unfortunate part, right? If during that chaos, RRQ was able to actually check for the forward alarm bot, this would be the perfect round setup for them. But since they haven't quite cleared that, Global Esports is able to reset their default. You can see on the minimap, you see Russ rejoining towards the A side. They still haven't pushed the alarm bot. They're nowhere near C right now.
RRQ, oh, they're just going in for a bit of a gamble now into that A side because of that fact. Will, still though, winning on some of these firefights.
But B is clear.
Lightning Fast doesn't have the paranoia any longer. So V is clear, they will be able to transition over, get the spike down. Xpharo with the timing will be able to catch a lot of these players. Benkai, the first to fall, next is gonna be Russ.
I mean, big round from RRQ. Sure, they don't spam the box or anything like that, but they're wary of it enough to make sure that a trade happens. And off of that kill, during all of that, they still leave their options open. Whenever you watch Lotus, the teams that are able to get enough of the rounds and attack are always going to be the ones that always leave one more chance open, right? It's, can you make one more rotation? You know, if we're going to A in the last 40 seconds, do we have B cleared when it comes to the 20-second mark? Things like that. Or do you have the C revolving door cleared by the 20-second mark? GE was doing a decent amount of that as well in the first half, but RRQ answering back right in form.
That's another thing. GE sometimes getting the right calls, right ideas, right reads. This time, just marking out some of these spots, Benkai will be able to start things off with a Marshall shot. Now smoked off, though. Gonna have to run back around. His team arriving.
No one's covering the spike.
Front door.
Oh. Jeez, I mean, no one was covering, but Elmimore, he'll cover himself.
Spike planted. They have all rifles, and they feeling pretty okay. At the same time, you got X-Fair on a bit of alert just in case someone does decide to pull a sneaky rotate through the doors. This time it's not quite happening just yet. Jemkin marking stairs. A bit of a skewer for two headshots, and RQ looking to tie things up.
And that's huge. That's a huge double kill because that catches Jemkin right up on the ult cycle as well. So Lockdown and Showstopper both 2 points away, which makes that Nightfall investment against the opponent's weak round quite worth it. I mean, just fast reactions from Elmimore. Seems like RQ also perhaps needing a little bit of that warm-up coming in. Now firing back, and that's going to draw out that timeout from GE. They've been feeling okay so far. I like this timing. They still have the lead, but now you're starting to see that RQ has the entire initiative, right? They go for a very slow round previously. They go for the final rotates, and then now they just go for that rush with the Nightfall all the way through A, regardless of weaponry on the other side.
And this is what I mean by, you know, RQ gets to dictate pace on this attacking side of the map.
We'll see what the adjustment is here from GE. Now, if you're RQ, I think you maybe check for a trap play on C again, right? Is it a fast push out of C, or could it be the trap from the revolving door with the paranoia? That's something that we still haven't seen, trap play or push out from C. Neither has really happened from GE. So if you're imagining a big change, that's something that RQ has to be ready for.
Not quite sure if it's going to be a trap play exactly just yet.
It's the op.
It's the op on Pulvi.
Yeah, it's not. They're not going to send the Showstopper, but I think RQ probably waiting for the Showstopper. Yeah, looking at their positions, they're waiting for a crossfire. They're not going to quite see it just yet.
Oh, and Blaze King with the Odin as well. Trying to play off of a little bit of time. RQ at the very least, pretty darn aware of it, tossing out the haunt just to check.
And this fast push into rubble, this is important for RQ because you're wondering, why are you trying to deny us so much rubble control with the Odin, right? Why this round? Why when we see that someone clears the odd right away and he just lands it on Flips?
Just walked into...
I think Flips heard the reload, so he thought he had time to creep all the way around, but Blaze King just fires right back.
At that exact spot. Very unlucky timing.
Yeah, the fake on the reload again. Finishes it off, 100 rounds still to go.
The last belt as well, so now he's gonna be a little bit more careful of it. Oh, makes use of Rust's Haunt, goes in for the clear wallbang shot. The pink mist, it's gonna be down to X-Faro, 5 HP. His team's completely gone.
And so is X-Faro. I mean, a clean round. I mean, this all falls apart when Flips dies, right? And you can't blame him, but you can absolutely give credit to Blaze King. Whenever you see, listen, people say that the Odins get lucky, but the real Odin users, they really play with your mind, right? They make you think that they're done spamming.
Exactly.
They make you think that you're only spamming one angle.
And then they swap to another angle.
Yeah, they keep it going. They have their own system, man.
It's a play of positioning is what it is. And I think, you know, it's not just the Odin as well.
A little Odin ceremony. We haven't seen that. Okay, I like it.
It's also the fact that, you know, there was that threat of the Showstopper. There was a little bit of movement, the smoke out from Lightning Fast, a bit of pressure just to funnel RQ into that A site. So game plan starting to work out a little bit for GE.
GE, do they read this? They do. They recognize that the smoke's a little too deep on B, and they think that it might be a trap onto C mount. It's a good reaction, and the op!
Holby's
good!
Great opener, the Dragon Roars. RQ's gonna have to recalibrate their strategies. Elmimore continuing to go in by himself, though, and he's got the spike. I'm a little bit nervous, Will. All right, now he's aware.
Well, all right. Spike given over. No one quite in range to hear that drop just yet. But Elmimore.
Oh,
the barrel. His barrel shows, and he has no idea. Oh,
slight whiff with the flick, but not too bad. But because of all of this, Elmimore calls that the site is clear. Spike goes down.
And the lockdown at the ready as well. Now Showstopper on the other side, so RQ, they have to still stop this way early.
Whoa!
Oh my gosh, right as the Paranoia hits, it's a good reaction.
Goes back in for a little bit more, just a little bit of greed, and it's not too good. Showstopper comes out from Pulvy, and
shut down after the alarm bot from 2GE.
So quick.
Perched up on top of that box once again, so Blaze King, he's wary of it. They're trying to clear him out, but they're all hiding right around that smoke and the pillar.
He's got to be very careful with his movements. Does it not have the mobility with that Odin? Swaps over onto the Vandal now, so being able to push in along with the squad, but he doesn't even need it. Rust tries to stick the defuse. The timer is still ticking away, and Flips is trying to play along with the time. The Snakebite lands. So even though Blaze King drops Global Esports, it's going to be RQ with the clutch round.
Man, I'm actually surprised. I want to give a lot of credit to Global Esports there, because by popping the Nano Swarm early while the smoke was still up, RQ was trying to fake out that they were all outside on Mound, right? It's a Mound plant. Hey, we've already left it empty after we got that kill on the Showstopper. Don't worry about the site. It was kind of a trap play setup, and Blaze King still checks for it. After he gets the first kill into 2G, they're still wary of X-Pharaoh. I mean, really, really heads up. But at the end of the day, the post-plant utility, I mean, the timing, the lockdown had been used as well. So RQ able to catch up one round again.
And what a crucial kill from 2GE as well. I mean, this guy just gets subbed in, does not miss a beat.
We heard Coach Ewok talk about it during the timeout episode. You know, 2GE's always there, you know, waiting for the chance. He knows how hard it can be to be that sixth man.
And he always stays ready as well. So very, very comfortable adjustments from RRQ. They are still keeping this match relatively competitive. Benkai now, this time the one with the Odin. The Nightfall getting sent out. Still catching RRQ. They have not been able to make it past the A site.
Oh, this had to have been a minimap read though as well, right from that Nightfall. Somehow is able to get the absolute shots through.
I think there was a ping on the map for him as well. So now back into the same spot. Paranoia just to flush him back. Hops over just in time. Blaze King holding Baby Door at the ready. So many angles being marked and covered by Global Esports. I don't know how RQ can make it through this.
I mean, they have to purely do it through frags, right? And it can only be B-site, and Global Esports is fairly aware of this because of the control they have across the entire map. I mean, look at Povy's position. He hasn't moved an inch. Mound is absolutely shut off. A tree is absolutely shut off. You know that they're still trapped in between B and A.
This is truly just the domain expansion of Global Esports right now. They are trapping them inside their realm. RRQ do not have any routes. Slowly finding back in that lead. And this is all after Coach Spin's timeout in round 18 as well.
Yeah, it's just a cold hard save, right? Doesn't matter about the creds or not. The chances just too far against us. RRQ making the choice to give 11 to GE. Now, yes, again, it looked very unlikely to pick up that round after the first two kills.
One down.
But they're going to have to figure out something else here. This Odin,
okay,
they've got to find, they've got to find an answer for this Odin. Because creeping in, I mean, it can work. Sure, you could consider and say, I misread the timing. But the thing is if you're going to creep in, either, you know, just holding rubble or making sure that there's some other utility to draw it out. Maybe opening the door first to make sure that he has to shoot the switch, something like that. And then just checking. That also helps check. Is the Odin still there?
Creeping in does feel a little bit too risky for my liking right now, Will.
I mean, what else are you going to do, though, right? I mean,
the utility.
Into tree? You can't clear that with the Odin spamming the entire time. If you have to get up to the switch first, and if they're going to be constantly checking, you got to do something else. You gotta do something else. I mean, yeah, if you get to the switch, sure, I'm all for it, right? Send the Prowler and things like that. But if they're expending utility first to get into rubble, right? It's just this chicken and the egg question, a catch-22, so to speak, for RRQ. And sometimes contact is the answer. But right now, it's gonna be a heavier push. They wanna basically draw out a little bit of attention elsewhere to see if they can then pressure onto A site.
We'll see if it is possible, but for now, it's really, really tough. We've got Pulvy, Russ, lightning fast, back in for C Mound. Sets up the turret, but it instantly gets dismissed. They definitely hear that Odin as well.
So you're hearing the Odin just a fast hit.
Wow. Oh, Jemkin gets a B.
Oh, that's a huge kill.
Jemkin with a big dive.
LB Moore as well. I mean, they're ready for this door opening as well. And this shuts down a lot of the options that GE had.
Unbelievable. Great adjustments coming in from RQ right now, and they already have the site. Nightfall even invested just to further hold Global Esports back. Benkai now slowly rethinking his options. Do I really want to approach Heaven?
No, I think you save if you're GE, right? Because here's the thing. I mean, the chances right now,
no matter
how easy B-Site is to retake, with the op and the Odin as well, and the positions you've already given over with the Nightfall, the chances are too slim, and you don't want to potentially give, let's say, Xfer a triple kill, let him maybe get close back to his lockdown, anything like that before the half ends. So while you have the lead, you know, you got kind of a, you know, kind of a gimme in that previous round after the initial kills. You give one back to RIQ, you reset.
So the question is, how will Global Esports come back into this next round now? Beat showing some slightly weaker spots. For the longest time now, Blaze King has set up his toxic screen from B to A, sometimes B to C. Is he going to have some more reinforcements on the side this time?
We'll have to see as Jemkin. I mean, that was a sick shot.
Yes.
So was Omimor's as well, but flying in and getting that pick onto Heaven, definitely a bit of a prediction.
I guess just leaving Russ in for B and then maybe setting up for a bit of a retake?
I mean, I thought, you know, maybe it was going to be a heavier stack onto B and C, go for a full retake onto A, but this time it's forward positioning on the Killjoy util. And this is a lot of setup for Blaze King, right? You're thinking, okay, Odin's here again. You know, no biggie. The door is open.
This is a spot that Elmimor is very comfortable with, so he flushes him out. The Prowler, the shot from Bully and Rust to fire back, though.
It's multi-layered. It's not just one guy, GE. They don't play simple Valorant.
Ooh. Sidestep with the Prowler out. Now swing.
Huge movement.
Oh, Xfero can't quite catch up. Down to the last two.
Oh, and you saw one as well on C-Mount.
Very potentially map point for Global Esports now. 2GE wanting to take matters into his own hands, but dropping the Pulvi. It's all down to the IGL flips.
Yeah, and while you have the pit, you know, you've got that lockdown, you've got an Odin on the other side. It's a tough choice to make. But at the end of the day, I mean, do you really want to give up that map point?
Got no choice.
I mean, I'm not going to blame him if he sends it, right? It looks nigh impossible either way.
30 seconds
but
left.
You have some mind games with it.
Poison's off. Best thing that you can do, right? I mean, plant the spike, maybe play around tree, but then you gotta be prepared for this entire squad. I don't think you want to invest Viper spit yet, but
yeah,
maybe now.
Yeah, lockdown's gone. Odin's gone. Sure, Odin gets picked up, but no lockdown.
Welcome to my world, Benkai's. No, it's Pulvi who's firing off.
No, he walks into it.
He walks into it.
I mean, this is just well played by GE, right? So he thinks the Odin spamming this angle,
I can do a quick
shoulder peek. I like the idea because what you're thinking is with the Odin spamming, the other guy's probably going to try to hold the defuse. So Flips, that's his process of elimination. But GE's one step ahead. They say, I'll spam it. You creep in because he can't hold this close angle if I'm spamming.
Exactly one of those, like, damned if you do, damned if you don't moments. It's just, I can feel the frustrations from Flip's side now. So unfortunately, even with all his best efforts, the Viper's Pit, the incredible shot up to Heaven, it's going to be map point for Global Esports.
Yeah, look at the way he was holding that too. I think Flip's kind of misread that angle. I thought he thought maybe he was shooting straight into the into tree, but Pulvi was already holding it at an angle, cutting that corner. So all in all, well played by GE. A little bit of panic from Flips as well.
Good effort though, but nonetheless, this is now an opportunity for Global Esports to steal this map win away. This was RRQ's map pick. They don't do well on this. We're going next to Global Esports' comfort pick on Icebox.
Yeah, we can talk about Icebox when we get there, but compositionally, I think you have to favor GE just a slight bit. Mm-hmm. So we'll see if RQ can take this to OT. They've never held the lead in this map.
Full set play into C. Just sending it down, lightning fast, able to do a bit of damage. Elmimor trades right back.
Jeff gets
already inside. A bit of Shroud of Set from 2GE, but he's done it one too many times. Russ is aware. Jemkin trying to get the timing on the swing, waiting for his teammates to arrive at the same time. But Blaze King now sets up the Viper's Pit. He can no longer push up front. Russ peeks out at the right time as Jenkins tries to fall back. That's going to be the third kill for Russ. LB4 now. The win against the world, and he's going to have to fight his way out of this entire squad.
I mean, you got 5 seconds to kill all these guys.
The crouch. Russ with the quad kill to close out the map. Global Esports, what an improvement.
I mean, listen, they've taken maps before, and they've looked better and better each time they've taken a map. But the fact that they shored up a lot of the weaknesses that they showed in the previous two times they played Lotus against DRX and Talon, I think that's a lot of hope here for GE. You know, Blaziken had some pop-off moments. Benkai has been having much more impact. He's been very quiet. So far in stage one. So overall, it's been a good map.
I think you can't talk about this unless you talk about the whole team. So let's let our analyst desk tell us exactly how they won.
Well, Spin did tease it earlier. It looks as though GE, indeed, this restructure is doing wonders for them. They look so much better. They look so much more well-coordinated. And I feel like this is a GE. This is the foundation they can build on going forward.
Yeah, I fully agree. I mean, I think this was a much better affair in terms of playing off of each other, playing for trades. No one was rarely getting caught out of position too much, I felt like. Benkai was doing a really good job being that lurker, kind of getting in some cheeky positions, finding some value kills. And the biggest part of this is, you know, we talked about him before, the player we wanted to see step up, have a big pop-off game. It was Blaziken, and he did. He was huge for them. He was all over the map, doing a good job, isolating some kills by himself, setting up with some utility, just being a really difficult Viper to play around.
You know, we saw a lot of threats from the Odin from teams like Lee because of Zest, right? GE, not really one of those teams where you kind of expect it to happen. Sure, they've kind of used it in the past, but, you know, it's a kind of lukewarm reception. But this time, Blaziken, Benkai, having kills through on tree with the Odin spams. Very, very strong output here from Global Esports.
Well, you know, I think it has something to do with Blaziken being all too familiar with the guys on the other side as well. I mean, let's not forget, Blaziken was up against his former teammates from that 2022 roster, I believe, that made it over to Champions Istanbul, right? Boom Esports that were there, and Blaziken was there. So he knows this guy's very, very well. Benkai as well, because he has been around, you know, the Southeast Asian scene for quite a while. So I feel like that confidence, coupled with whatever GE has been workshopping this entire time, just led to this, you know, this first map victory.
Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, pop-off games again, Blaziken, but also Povy having a lot of impact with his operator, doing a good job kind of breaking some space, out-dueling Jemkin, which is not something you may have thought coming into today's match, that he was going to be the better raise on Lotus. But Jemkin was really struggling here. He had a couple, you know, banger opener kills, but other than that, he was relatively shut down. Polvi was winning a lot of those duels against him as well, so it really made things difficult for RRQ to get any momentum.
Yeah, again, it's just Global Esports finding that nice little tune or sync as they try to create these plays. There was a lot of points where we saw, I think, RRQ trying to go for those heroics. One of the biggest takeaway players here has got to be LB Moore. He was putting himself on the line just to get these multi-kills. Sure, there's some rounds where it wouldn't work, but when it does, you see RRQ getting, trying to get back on that horse, and it worked somewhat. They were very close here with Global Esports up until the last couple of rounds.
But I think there was a few issues with LB Moore when he got some of those multi-kills where he overheated and overpeaked on some angles that he didn't need to. Like, he picked up that 2K on the defender side on Lotus on C site and then swung the corner, and it just didn't work for him, you know.
Yeah.
Things like that where it's like he gets that confidence and then he gets a little too far out of the rest of his team. There wasn't any backup there for him, and that was a big problem in general, I felt like, for RRQ, where they were trying to make hero plays and there wasn't any backup behind it. It's okay if you get a double frag and you feel like you've got a chance for the third. He had the tether on his opponent, but he didn't have anybody else there to support him, so he just died for nothing, essentially, when he could have made that, you know, potentially a trade or something like that. And that's part of the reasons that RRQ faltered here on Lotus.
There were a lot of rounds where an RRQ looked very overwhelmed, which is not something that you can usually say for a team that has gone, you know, comfortably toe-to-toe with Gen G, for example, right? It just seemed like there were a lot of very unnecessary rounds wherein they were a bit confused, you know, their attention wasn't exactly fully focused, and I'm not sure if it's because of the changes that have come in, you know, very last minute for this team, or maybe it was just because they weren't used to this pace that GE was showing them.
Yeah, you know, we were just talking about how it could be putting them in a spell, how differently Global Esports approached the start of this series. And seemingly like that, we saw RQ try to do other things as well, where we saw Xfero put out the operator as well. It worked somehow, a couple of
kills. That one flick.
That was
pretty nasty, but the rest of it was...
But then everything else is like Global Esports knew exactly, oh, if it whiffs, we flood him in, that opens up one part of the map, and then we're golden.
Yeah, I feel like, you know, this is a new energy that GE has been showing, right? And I feel like, you know, this is, you know, going into Icebox, RRQ, by the way, their map pick was Lotus. Going into Icebox right now, I mentioned earlier, Paperthin, I'm not feeling too good having voted for RRQ, especially since we know that their Icebox is pretty strong. But GE, with this form, with this brand new, you know, confidence that they have, and going into Icebox, I don't know.
Yeah, good luck. I mean, if Lightning Fast starts popping off on this map and...
Exactly.
Still, Blaze King and, you know, Pulvy are playing well, then forget it. I mean, that's such a difficult team to overtake. RQ, they look solid. It's pretty well coordinated. I mean, Jemkin seems pretty comfortable on the Jett on this map, even though he's kind of more known for his raise. But this is still going to be tough. This has to be now GE favored with the way that they've been playing so far today, going into their best map. Yeah, they're going to have to dig deep for RQ.
Yeah, and again, one of the, I guess, imposing questions there is, is RQ going to rely heavily once more on Jemkin here? Because, again, when they face against Team Secret, he was the one that, I think it was you that mentioned it, bailed him out a couple of rounds, especially on once they were in overtime.
Yeah, well, speaking of imposing questions, we have one for you guys, obviously. We do have our Guess and Gain segment right now. And I do believe we have some updates, by the way, on our... on our board over here. The first big update that we have is you will notice William over here in a brand new position. This is because we've carried over intel from the Korean broadcast and he has deranked accordingly.
You know,
to be fair.
I was you know, talking with him yesterday. It's like, he finally beat me. You're in diamond. And he says, no, they carried over my my guessing game on Korean and now I'm gold. Really? And I was like,
you're way too happy for
I know.
You are way too happy. Meanwhile, Achilles and I we're just chill over here in bronze. This is what we call the acceptance stage. So we're pretty happy over here, but our question for today is which team will get the more pistol kills in map 2? More pistol kills, by the way, so this means that it's not just the pistol rounds.
Okay.
Let's get
okay.
out yeah. our boards here. I will promise to
just
write
the team, right?
My answer a little bigger.
You could vote for a tie. Apparently you could vote for a tie, but I don't know.
You
I don't think that's super likely.
Okay, let's see. Can I copy the answer over here of our audio? But well, no, I am prepared to defend this answer. All right, you guys ready?
Hell yeah.
3, 2, 1, show! Man, I still write really small.
That is still small.
You really got to write a little bit bigger.
Anyway.
Thank you for the zoom in.
I need it, okay? In more ways than one.
So sorry, I don't have hands for this.
We have Paperthin with an RRQ.
Oh.
Yeah. No, because I'm picking against what I think is really going to happen.
Right. Yeah. Your meta. Your personal meta.
Yeah, exactly. I think GE looks really good right now. And even though this year the pistol rounds haven't been great, like that's kind of historically something they've been known for. So sure, let's go with RRQ. Yeah.
And Azurai going all in with his bet.
Why not? You know,
No more explanation needed.
I've kind of given up already on thinking why. I just like, whichever team I predict this day and during the minigames or the guessing games, I'm just going to keep following it.
Well, I have G on here just because if they keep up the performance they had in that first map, I don't know. I mean, I think they will definitely get more pistol rounds. Putting this down right now.
Bring me back to Platinum, please,
we prepare.
G.
As we prepare for map number 2, we're heading into Icebox. And if we remember G on here, they look very, very comfortable with some very memorable performances. I think, you know, again, with this renewed energy here, we could end up with the same thing.
Yeah, I mean, if they can keep that same level of, like, rotational kind of composure and getting everybody in the right places at the right time, and Benkai continues to be a nuisance, all these things put together really threw RRQ for a loop. Blaze King just being that player that we know he's capable of being. I have a hard time imagining with Lightning Fast as well, getting that upgrade that... this is going to be easy for RQ. Can they do it? Yes. But we're going to have to see a very different team than what we saw there on Lotus. They looked lost at times. They looked a little bit confused. I guess the good news is you don't have to worry about an Odin. There's that, usually.
Maybe?
Unless you play Harbor, then some teams will grab an Odin to, like, spam the Cove or something. But
Perhaps. I don't want to count it out entirely just yet.
Who knows?
I mean, yeah, exactly. Who knows, right? But we will find out as we head into Icebox. We are about to get into Agent Select right now. Are we expecting any big changes, you think? I mean, GE mentioned the restructuring. Does this mean also a brand new agent composition despite them performing very well?
Probably not. I think it's just more refining the tools that was already available for them. It's more of like how they approach things rather than changing up what they do. And I'm about to get slapped. No, it's the same thing.
You're good.
Okay, but one of the things I do want to add here, though, is I felt like when I was watching the RRQ match up against Team Secret, didn't really have too many huge lurks and such, not a lot of big mid controls, I'd say, compared to Global Esports that we saw Polvi, we saw Benkai really wanting to challenge control in spaces like such as Kitchen. So that's definitely something to watch out for here.
And Lightning Fast does it too. He goes under Tube a lot to get some of those those big impact frags onto the B side on retakes and stuff like that. So yeah, this is going to be tough. I mean, RRQ's going to have to really dig deep here, really come up with a good game plan. Because when you're playing that Gekko, sometimes you get so tunneled in on those executes and those retakes.
Oh, I don't know. GE are feeling good. You can see Blazing over there waving, blowing some affectionate kisses over there to his friends over on RRQ. We're going to see, though, can GE close this out? Can RRQ bounce back? Big questions over here as we toss it on back to William and Quack.
That's right. Thank you very much, Mika, Paper Thin, and Asurai. This is the Global Esports that is still looking for their first win. Very close to it right now, but you never quite know. I think Paper Thin has a good point because Flips did get zero kills on this map last week, Will.
Yeah, that's true. Can he make the same magic happen again today? It will require Omi Mordor to also get 30 kills. We should remember that. So we'll see if it happens. But I love what the Jess pointed out about map control overall. GE seems to be very fluid on this Icebox. Sure, RRQ, they've been comfortable to pick it. But also compositionally, that Sage creates a lot of problems for these util dump type compositions. You know, it's not as hard as the KO Gekko here for RRQ. It's the Silva. But it's still going to be a lot of front-loaded util. So curious to see what the adjustments are.
That's right. They got to watch out for that Sage, especially with how flowy Lightning Fast can get on it sometimes.
And look, already mid-control. Right off the bat on the pistol here from Benkai. Okay. He's watching Tube. He gets through past the turret. So now RRQ, because of that Poison Cloud, they have to have someone Kitchen to make sure they don't get caught off guard.
Hence X-Pharaoh marking that area, but at the same time, more worried about Jemkin for the time being, playing up around yellow. Time has passed, so he's trying to reposition up around. Flips able to catch the first point of contact. Rust no longer able to find that space into A-site.
Oh, spot the missile. Not able to land the first shot, but I love the back out from Jemkin, right? Just wait for support. You've got a 4v5 or 5v4.
Yeah, not expending the dash just yet either. Now he goes in for it because he's looking for the clear headshot, but Benkai strikes when the iron is hot. Look at this. Global Esports flooding the site now. 2GE will be able to fight back with his classic. Benkai repositioning up back onto his top.
No,
Polvi, yes, is the one who is sneaking up behind yellow. Jemkin still has a lot of work cut out for him, and only 6 rounds in the chamber. It's going to be tough for him because he doesn't quite know that positioning.
Really good patience from Benkai, right? Despite being down in numbers, Benkai is just going to wait until the plant happens. It's a pistol round. You've got a Sage. You know that you can force the plant. Povy even going up the rope just to make sure he gets a little bit of early info as the plant goes down. And Benkai just waits for the opportune moment once he hears them trying to spam against the wall. So while, you know, RRQ had good info and they had good reactions to it, at the end of the day, it's that mid control. And this is not something we say every day for Icebox. It's not a map where mid is used all too often. But the fact that you're even able to create that pressure in the pistol, look at already what it does on the eco. RRQ now has to make sure that they're checking early on down that tube.
Even if you are just kind of lurking up around that area, even a delayed push, a delayed peek works out so well. It is still just the pistol, but I am pretty excited because Global Esports could come up with a big win. But what just happened? Flips! Elmi Moore, the classics! It's happening again!
You know, I just want to let the desk know, if you thought that GE was going to look just as strong and buy more guns off it, of course it's going to be RRQ with more pistol kills! It's not even the sheriffs, it's just all Flips!
What? A flawless thrifty win? Are you kidding me?
With classics. I mean, normally RRQ does this with sheriffs.
Careful.
Holy.
And it just happens because they were playing some of these close-ranged positions. Close-range duels, the wide swings.
But you had a stinger.
You weren't ready for it, Will.
Bro, Arashiku Classic, bro.
I mean, hey, market your stuff, man. You got the opportunity. He knows that we're going to pick out that audio clip. Right
there. All right, Flips no longer. Zero kills on this map. But here we go.
Tower down.
Global Esports now, off of such a loss, just kind of dazed and stunned, having to recalibrate, re-engage. They've got the upgraded pistols. Blaze King will do a bit of damage to him. That's one Bulldog gone, a second rifle gone. What is going on?
I mean, we've seen this happen a lot, especially in Pacific. You know, thrifties for days. Trade it back and forth. But you do still have the rifles on the side of RQ, so that Sage util not going to be as damaging. It's not going to be as impactful.
Very prepared to. Oh, take these bites though. Look at this.
Listen, we've seen some crucial kills with peeks like that, but the timing, the way he peeks out of it is just a little bit too deep into the screen, so he's not able to get the quick jiggle. And the thing is RQ had thrashed this round. But now, it doesn't seem like a good investment.
It's just a nightmare for round, Will. You know, they're trying to deal with the spike plant, but everyone's peeking out one by one from RQ. They're doing it solo. And that's just not what you want to have. I mean, the same thing. They had the idea to kind of go in for a bit of a trade up around top boiler, but it just didn't work out. Blaze King was prepared to take that shot.
Yeah, and I do like the save decision here from Jemkin, right? You don't want to give too many upgrades. They're coming for it because they have nothing to lose from GE. If they get the kill, it's another upgrade. It's more credit saved up.
Oh, yeah. Lightning Fast was, like, grinning from ear to ear on his player cam.
Oh, no! He doesn't even keep the rifle. Yeah, that's unfortunate. Now, RQ, because they were the ones who picked up the upgrades in that last round, it's not as bad, right? They'll still be able to try to make do with what they have. It's going to be a broken round with one person not having buys. This is just excellent use, peeking around the spike there for Blaze King.
What an incredible flick as well. I mean, that's exactly it. Look at every one of these kills. It's all RQ peeking out one by one. But you are absolutely right. So because they do get to keep their economy going for a little bit more, and Jemkin now with the operator swings out. Will be able to punch right through. Tries to go in for the vertical flick, but not quite happening just yet. Russ pushing up front along with the Mosh Pit too, able to keep one of the RQ players trapped.
Yeah, trusting in that op a little bit too much for RQ. Pushes out a bit of an overheat. You're going to hear all this info though.
Okay. Might be able to set up a bit of a flank. Catches Lightning Fast on the back turn.
And this, by keeping control of mid, RQ can now regroup as a three-man. So I like the call, right? Even though you have a read that it's most likely a rotate back to A because of the last movement of the Sage, you're just going to wait. You're going to go for that retake. You have the numbers advantage.
No util on the side of Global Esports as well. RQ is in a very good spot. Has the angle. Russ tries to take the initiative against them, but not quite able to deal with the operator. Pulvi has no choice but to shoot his way out of this one. Goes in for a spray transfer. Runs out of ammo. No. Drops back down. Very easily heard. Jemkin trying to play it patient and safe. Oh, but what a flick. Back on towards the head. 2G has to clutch this out. This round, RQ had the advantage. Pulvi sneaks up the top of the window. I can see you.
The Phantom lights up on top of the scoreboard. GE fans have been waiting for games like these. And today he's answering back. Raise diffs on the first map and an excellent clutch on the second.
Ridiculous.
This shot on Jemkin was absolutely nutty.
He's just ready for it. Took a little bit of damage in second round, but they just shrug it right off, Will.
That's a huge blow to RQ, both in-game and mentally as well.
Economy running dry now. Only more still taking pot shots against them, though. Benkai firing right back.
Look at
going
these trades.
For duels.
Yeah, I mean, look at that. They're never letting, you know, a death happen for no reason. I mean, Paper Thin talked about it on the desk as well, but the fact that they are willing to trade, they're accepting that, yeah, we can have good reads for the start of the round. You know, obviously when we make a mid-round decision, it's about the reads. But afterwards, you have to be ready. And the media peak afterwards, I like it. Not having to invest the wall there. You know, you have the weapons advantage.
Global Esports, they get to death ball in this round if they want to. Flip spots out the little elbow, though. Ooh. Thrash comes out. Flip's stuck in a bad position. Unfortunately, not quite able to escape. That was just a really unlucky one. Xperia now with the one and done. It's just not quite meant to be. Barrier comes up. Jemkin tries to swing around the side. What is that flick back and back? Tailwinds away into safety. Run around the max so he reloads. Back to a 2-on-2. Lightning fast. Trying to sneak around the site to find a duel.
Now the spike's down though. They don't have it recovered yet.
Okay, that gets away, but what? Jemkin, just a little bit of a peek and it's enough to take him down. Back to the 1-on-1.
Blaze King!
Even though it's at high and low, he takes it all.
I mean, so far, this is what everyone has been asking for from GE, right? It's more firepower. It's Pulvi proving why he was picked up all the way from EMEA. It's Blaze King. Why was he picked up from Challengers? Why was he always hailed as one of the stronger players in Indonesia? It's all coming together. I mean, Lightning Fast, Rush, sure, they've been holding the line for a long time. But Benkai also with some steady trades today. Oh, he's going at it. I mean, GE, they haven't felt this confident all season.
It's just Indonesian Valorant stuff. But again, I mean, you're absolutely right. The firepower from Global Esports is really showing in these rounds. At the same time, though, you can't really, you know, fault RQ. Jemkin had some incredible frags.
I mean, listen, in terms of like 2v1s and clutches, unless it's teams usually like they're absolutely peaking one by one, things like that, it's generally props to the person who clutches. I mean, that previous round, sure, you know, it starts as an eco. So quite frankly, GE getting a little messier in the beginning part of the round. But at the end of the day, they get a little lax. They think that they are able to just swarm him with the numbers advantage in that 2v1 situation. I mean, Jemkin does everything he can to try to keep them in the game. Now that the op is out, we'll see how things work out. But RQ, whenever they get this op, they tend to rely on it quite a bit to make their rotations, right? They just post up the operator, and then they wait about 10, 20 extra seconds
to see if
that same thing happens.
2G is going to have to be wary.
Get out of my way!
There have been a lot of movements up around Nest for the past couple rounds now. So RQ made the heavy investment, but guess what? Global Esports headed back into B. 2G completely backs off. Unfortunately, sustains a bit of damage. That operator just still posted up. The rest of the team from RQ now, unfortunately, not quite able to deal against this because Global Esports has already taken up so much space. The Thresh will connect. Flips wants to capitalize on his kill.
Yeah, but they're watching
for it. They're watching from Hut. And it's just such a good angle. The cover from Lightning Fast. You even have the Viper's Pit up. Although there are some kills on the board now, Jemkin marking some of these angles. Lightning Fast with what an incredible swing. The pit's still up, and Blaze King slipping in and out of it. Benkai watching out from the back now. A bit of a burst, but not quite connecting the shot. Still, though, timer running out. How do you deal with this Viper's Pit? Blaze King has snake bites for days.
Toss the last one out. He's trying to creep in. The reload hears it! The reload!
No time, though.
But no time. Oh, Jemkin plays his heart out. Back-to-back rounds. But here's the other thing. I mean, GE, the real good reaction they had here was normally what they do a lot of times if it's a bit of a hard hit onto B, is they'll wall off part of the site and they'll dig deep into Snowman. This time, they wall off Snowman. Say they're gonna fill the site. As soon as the wall gets broken, Pulvi makes a judgment call to say, we gotta fight for Snowman control back. He goes for it, he gets detained. He actually draws away the Thrash aggro. Lightning Fast covers him from the grates. The teamwork is just snappy today from GE.
Whether or not it's the mental coach or just the amount of work that they've done, the amount of work that the coaches have done to adjust their calling the previous days, you know, Benkai being a little bit more communicative, it's all working out incredibly well for Global Esports today. Meanwhile, for RQ, I mean, just tiny things, fractions of a second where someone peeks out a little bit too late or fires a little bit too late. Unfortunately, even though Jemkin is topping the scoreboards, the rounds aren't going their way.
Jemkin surely wants to redeem his name a little bit as well after a very rough first map.
It's not quite happening just yet. Too many targets, too many variables. but at the very least, they've gathered some information.
Yeah, they gathered information, but they're not able to hold on to that area, right? And I think that's what we're really starting to see at the top level of Valorant these days, is simply getting information, passive information just is not enough. You have to have a reaction. You have to still maintain 50% control of the map. Right now, RQ, they're getting pressed in. They're losing control bit by bit on both A site and B.
Information goes bad after a little while. And that's why they're expending, investing utility just to clear and continue to try and regain control. 2G is in a pretty tricky spot, and unfortunately the high and low catches him down. Pull V, quick double to open up the B site. The rest of the squad has arrived. Look at the snakebite lineups as well. Elmi Moore unfortunately is forced back out. Benkai now along with the turret, maybe not quite able to land the shot. But at the very least, now very aware that there is a potential push from mid, but because it is a 2-on-4, RQ has no choice but to save.
This is rough. This is very rough for RQ. Meanwhile, very good for GE. Even that toxic screen that cuts across this B site, it actually leaves so small of a corner that it is really hard to try to peek out of that on that second floor. And like you said, because they're aware that some teams, especially RQ, they've shown it before in this map as well, they'll try to still go for a jiggle out of that screen. They even have the snakebite lineup. I mean, the setups are very good for Polvi today as well. The confidence dash up onto yellow. But the toxic screen goes up right before it, so he's masked from the second floor. It all comes together for GE. A rifle picked up for Jemkin. It's just two Vandals being carried over. Not the best for RRQ this upcoming round 8.
It is devastating, Will. I mean, you said it all. Polvi set up, talked about information and how, you know, you gotta be a little bit more active with it. But Global Esports are controlling the pace right now. First of all, yeah, they are making their presence known. And at the same time, you've got Benkai on lurks throughout mid. RQ has to be very cognizant of all of these moves, and sometimes it gets a little bit overwhelming. But at this moment in time, this week of VCT Pacific, when you have Global Esports 5 wins in a row, how do you come back from that?
So this time they're going to try to actually keep control of whatever information they gain on the A side. But GE seems to be ready for it.
Okay. Jemkin tries to take contact. Oh, but kind of body blocked for a second. 2GE trying to fire back, but it's just not going to happen. Global Esports, they make it away. They'll take that one.
This is a position Flips has held during kickoff. GE surely is aware of it.
Oh!
You will not kill my ally.
Got that res. And we've been seeing this a lot. Polvi and Lightning Fast double peeking. Polvi taking the lead. And now with the res, it's even better.
Oh, I was thinking about it.
Yeah, it's just too risky of a position though, right?
Better to invest that lockdown in another round. Grows back around and he will be able to find an angle. Takes down a single player. Wingman,
30 seconds left.
Spike Plant, not quite yet going through because of that Hunter's Fury. Now the lockdown gets deployed. Global Esports tries to back out. Lightning Fast, we'll have no choice but to drop. Rust trying to hold it up from around yellow, not quite expecting his fur to be pushed up that much front. 2GE now coming back up from the other side. It's Rust keeping things alive for Global Esports. All on his lonesome. Separated from the pack, 2GE cannot do much.
No, you have to save. You have
Ouch.
To. I mean, 1 HP for Russ. What a hold on yellow.
The fact that he recovered and stabilized that one.
I mean,
he
Russ
definitely looks shocked.
Russ
yes.
has been grinding, man. It's so clear. You know, and listen, I said it on social media as well. Like, I accepted. I was a doubter. You know, Rust fans and GE fans told me he's been grinding. He's been looking good in ranked. He's been looking good on stream. And in my head, I was like, well, until I see it on the stage, it doesn't mean much. We've heard so much about players that grind away and they can't convert it on the stage. And I, you know, Rust has made it to internationals before, but, you know, the high days were cut short in the past.
Today, though, today.
I mean, not just today, right? The stage one, sure, GE was rocky overall, but Russ and Lightning Fast both have been just getting better and better each week.
And it's all because of that grind. It's all because of the belief from the fans. It always feels great, and the support means so much. RRQ needs a little bit of that right now. I'm surprised it took this long for the timeout to be called. 7-1 is the score. this is Global Esports' comfort pick after all.
Yeah, and listen, we're not even seeing the vast difference in the compositions come into play just yet, right? It's a lot of these early duels where GE will always at least get the trade, and then they'll keep hold of the areas on the map. It's not even necessarily about the number of frags, but it's the fact that GE still keeps the initiative. Sure, they're on the attack, so it's a bit easier to do that. And that's always been the trouble with defending on Icebox. You know, you kind of have to push out from one side or the other pretty aggressively. And on A, you'll want to set up for the high-lows on pipes and things like that, but it's a very close angle. It's not the easiest here for ROQ, but they'll have to find a way. And now Povy has his own operator as well.
Oh, yeah. Something that ROQ might not anticipate. Who knows? Timeout called.
I mean, look at G's position. They're waiting for a hard push out. They are waiting for a hard push out. It's not going to come, but they'll wait for it.
Killed my trap. Default hold for now. I mean, this is week three, William. Very tricky stuff. ROQ actually on the verge of losing this match, and along with it, maybe their chances of making it to playoffs. Elmi Moore caught unaware, caught lurking, just up by the window.
It felt like he was trying to find an angle right above the poison cloud, and maybe he wasn't quite happy with his sightline or something. He was not paying attention to inside tube at all. They had already made it past the poison cloud. I mean, sure, you can set the turret back up. You already have flips in garage. This time, he doesn't have to show his back. That's always haunted him a little bit in the past.
Just a little bit punishing. And look at the patience from Global Esports. Blaze King marking the back. Benkai lurking up around mid. No movements from A. And Russ is still just trying to set up or at least take a peek into the site.
Yeah, I mean, GE, they have no reason not to necessarily hit the A site. This pit is detrimental, but it doesn't cover the entire site. They still have a Sage Wall as well. So there you go. It blocks off right outside of the pit. I mean, it's a good setup here for GE.
Russ gets to walk in kind of more or less for free. 2GE still hovering up around rafters, but the spike is down now. And there is a lot of heat breathing down the back of Jemkin. He will be able to turn around and feel it. He's trying to come back in.
Yeah, I mean, that lurk.
Oh, man.
Ruins everything. Jemkin has to clear
it.
Even then, though, 1v3. He's got to go for the save again. I mean, it's a correct decision, but it's the worst correct decision every round so far. Three rounds in a row.
Wow. He's still hot for the duels, though. Able to flick back. There's the fourth. Oh, my goodness.
I mean, listen, sure, get your ace, man, because you're going to need a consolation prize after this.
Aww.
Can't even finish it. Obviously, great four kills from Jemkin. But really, the focus is on the fact that GE is reading RQ like a book. And here's the thing, even that round, right, you have the pit, but you know if they have the pit, they're not going to fill the site. So you're basically going to creep up, and once you get right up to that starting point of the site plant, then you put up the Sage Wall, it denies any of the flood all the way to the plant, you send the wingman to make sure they're not breaking the wall too easily, and GE knows how this comp is played on the opposite side.
It's very familiar knowing how to work around the pit, and it's just... It feels bad for RQ right now. Like you mentioned, making all the right technical decisions, you know, on paper. But unfortunately, it's not something that converts into a round win. And if that round wins are something that RQ needs desperately. Flips, able to play off of the operator. 2GE now holding out garage. A little bit of damage, and it makes RQ look a little bit better.
Yeah, at least you don't have the Jet or the Viper now. So that B site looking much, much less likely. So look at RQ's position. They want to just make sure that they're not showing their backs. They're making sure that they have mid covered from various angles.
Nice.
Big pick on the A flank as well.
I mean, the positioning this round, not exposing too much, not going up too up front. Offshot onto the window, barrel spotted. It's a team ace, it's a flawless win. RRQ keeps themselves afloat.
Yeah, afloat's the perfect way to describe it. They're gonna desperately need these last two rounds if they wanna feel any sort of comfort going into the second half. They can stabilize at a 4-8, it's not too bad. But this time Flip's not alone on that lurk. That catches GE off guard a little bit, and then a heavier focus onto mid. Knowing that GE is going to like to work it if they lose a couple members. RQ slowly, but slowly catching on to GE's patterns.
Good timeout from Coach Ewok. Good adjustments from the players. Let's see if they can keep it up, because they are still very much in this fight. Although they only have two rounds, it's not over yet. Global Esports starting to fan out now, though. Jemkin trying to catch a sneaky one.
Lightning Fast was tagged, but he's ready for it. He knows the pitch is coming.
Ooh.
Oh, Elmimore. Oh, this is, I mean, it was the call from Lightning Fast, right? That I need backup. I'll try to hold the first whip around. And Russ is trying to hold the other pinch coming out on the main path of A main. But, I mean, you just couldn't land the first shot. There's not much to it there.
Because RQ's taking things into their own hands and trying to fight the pace of Global Esports now. They peek out. Something that Lightning Fast couldn't quite react to in time. But the rest of the team not backing down. They pushed into the B site.
They're not quite sure about Blaze King being stuck in. He doesn't know!
At least a bit of cover from Xpero from mid. Now you've got Elmimore marking things from Snowman. Trying to play around yellow. Pulvy, can he do it? He's got so many targets to hit. Jemkin on the operator. Just sniped right down. All the way into sight, into yellow. RRQ keeps themselves going.
I mean, RRQ's been losing pretty badly, so we haven't talked about it much, but Jemkin's shots have been on fire this map. Right? He was a little bit heavy on that first map of Lotus. Definitely showed a bit of a raised diff. But this time on the jet, at the very least, the snots are just absolutely sharp.
I mean, he's always been that duelist ever since on Scars from Ascension. He's been talked about, and this is why RRQ picked him up. Still needs so much more just to find these rounds. Sometimes doing a little bit of heavy lifting.
And I like this timeout from GE. A bit of a counter timeout a couple rounds in, but, you know, cool them off as they're starting to heat up. Make sure you can reset. If you can get the 9-3, even better. Things like that.
Sure, but it is like the last round of the first half, so a very kind of a curious one, but nonetheless, definitely looking for the 9-3 because once you go into halftime, if they can take that round, now we're just looking at four more for Global Esports to make it to map point.
Yeah, I mean, listen, you get two timeouts, and sure, you might need them both in the second half, but you're so far ahead that I think...
Just want to close it out.
Yeah, if you're forced to use both to try to make sure you're not getting caught up, I think those timeouts end up feeling bad either way, right? Because you're kind of giving a chance for the enemies to reset as well. So I don't mind it. Like, I'm not going to say it's objectively, you know, the best timeout or anything like that. But obviously, especially based on maybe what he's hearing in the comms, things like that. But mostly to cool off Jemkin on the other side, 16-6-2, single-handedly keeping RRQ afloat.
That round, even with a spike going off, able to snap onto heads like that. Critical. Global Esports now taking things a little bit slow, at least for the time being. RRQ has game plans to work against this garage push.
Oh, this
Jemkin
is a trap.
Now up on top.
The mosh,
the dizzy, everything, it's all tossed in. Elmimore firing shots through the toxic screen, catching Global Esports.
Oh, this was a nasty setup from RRQ. I mean, the lineup on the mosh, and then the, it's just overall, the same, everything was so good. And then the high-low with the Blade Storm.
Blaze managing to lurk through mid, though, will be able to look for a bit more damage. Here's the footsteps at the last second, turns around. But look at the shots, just firing it through, making him feel uncomfortable.
I mean, what a read after that timeout. What a read. And they pull out a new one from the strat book.
Might have been like a bit of a counter timeout from Coach Spin, but RRQ made sure to make use of it.
Yeah, I mean, very good read. Very good read from RRQ. And the reason I don't mind it is, again, you haven't seen a really hard push on to B from GE, right? Generally, they're always kind of scouting for information on A. They take over Pipe's control a little bit, and then they slow creep into B. You see that final timeout, you think they might do something a little different. You purposely try to bait them in. You, as the top screen comes out, you just show one Vandal trying to spam through it on a tempo. Say, hey, we're just trying to hold this off by trying to go for some of these, you know, spams through the smoke, see if we can get a lucky kill. And GE just bites right on. The recon dart, the mosh, the thrash comes out. It's the read on the thrash as well, overall. You know, a desperately needed way to round out the first half for RRQ. It finishes on a high note, but overall they were still so far behind. So it's not comfortable just yet. Love from Turkey. Welcome, welcome.
Hey.
That's just see it.
Awesome. I mean, it's a very satisfying round. A lot of satisfying support from the fans all over. Lightning Fast as well gets a bit of love.
Dude, Lightning Fast has been, I mean, he didn't get much of a chance last year, but you can tell he knows how much it means to be given this shot, right? The lone remaining member of GE's starting squad. And he is making full use of it. And oftentimes on this icebox, it's on that defense that he pops off with this Sage all around that A site, the master of it. We'll see if RQ can break up that pacing.
Yeah, because so far, Global Esports has been dominating the pistols today. Coming in with a bit of a game plan as well. Lightning Fast makes a bit of noise, hops up around pipes, and then the drone comes out, walls it off just to eliminate any potential secondary angles. Someone's Toxic there. Screen up. It's just walls and walls.
Yeah, this is always going to be the trouble. This time they're able to get rid of the wall pretty early, but at the end of the day, GE.
Oh, Ben. GE just knows how to work around it. They know they need to draw RRQ out, and with the angles, Lightning Fast, Russ managing to take down so many players. It's all down to 2GE. He tries to swing around, but Blaze King descends upon him.
Yeah, you can tell Blaze King's feeling a little confident today. He's got a couple moves up his sleeves, trying to prove a point here against some of his old friends on the other side.
Yeah, this is now my time to join the Pacific.
It's been a long time coming for Blaze King, for sure. But yeah, that Sage wall, I mean, sure, it comes out early, so RQ is able to break through it. But the fact of the matter is RQ, they always have to worry about using that util dump too early.
Definitely is very pesky. Because they want to, you know, break through. They want to deal with all these walls that Global Esports puts up, because if they don't, that's going to be a lot of map control. Now just opting to rush through B-side instead, knowing they want to deal with Lightning Fast. But Blaze King, Master of Arms, swaps over onto the Classic, gets the triple. Benkai now firing a shot of his own on the site, and even Xfero, who tries to peek out from back mid, gets spotted by Lightning Fast.
If you must fall, sure, anti-eco, but what you can tell is the confidence is there for GE. I mean, they're playing like we haven't seen them before. Even the maps they've won, it wasn't with movement like this, with confidence like this, fighting as if they just can't lose. We talk about that so often, and I feel like viewers who have watched BCT for a while now will know when we see that, right? The running guns, things like, I just know I will hit my shot first, right? I just know I'm ahead of this guy in the mind games.
Yes.
That type of movement, the reactions coming out from Blaze King, the hype is there.
The glow in their eyes. They know that they can win these fights. That's why they're taking them. That's why they're going for it, Will. And now Pulvy marking the angle. He's threading the needle. Beware, RRQ. There goes that first peek, and instantly Pulvy flicks onto Jemkin's head. A rifle snatched right away from under his arms.
Man, and against the Sage now, with your Gecko Silvacop, you don't have your jet.
Gotta watch out for the trap.
Yeah, all you have to do is cut audio. This is your only chance, Dizzy. And it gets spotted.
Wall up, Lightning Fast playing around him. Russ is providing him with so much support. RRQ can't quite walk through. They've suffered that loss from the pistol round. They don't want to make it happen again.
They've already lost
their diver.
Yeah, RQ knows cutting audio is the only option.
Uh-oh.
But he gets spotted again. He doesn't know that, but he is spotted. So GE's very well aware of this.
Oh,
they've already filled the site.
And that's just Lightning Fast making the quick reactions. Pulvy firing another shot off from screens. Spotted out, flips off the top. Pulvy with the final shot too. It's a flawless round win. The bonus for Global Esports. This is it.
I mean, you have to force here, otherwise it's smash point. It's a terrible round to have to force on, but they had to buy the full armors last time because of the Outlaw, and the Outlaw's still there, but you don't have much of an option, right? You can't play to not lose. So RRQ really finding themselves up against the wall here. And what? I mean, this is again what I was talking about with the compositional differences, right? The wall comes out. I mean, sure, your jet is down as well, But if you use your util dump too early, then they can just refill the site afterwards, right? If you hold on to it late, then you don't have as much information, things like that.
And what more can RQ do other than to full send it with their force buy in this round?
Oh, but the trap
up
play.
The orb, Blaze King, very aware of it, and they've managed to check the angle. Pulvi still with the outlaw. RQ's just waiting for a bit of a peek.
I like that he doesn't dash out, right? I mean, I don't know about going back in, but he'll find one.
Now they know it's the outlaw. They have no choice but to swing out. Russ is here. Global Esports, this is their round. This is their match. Swapped on over to the Sheriff. Doesn't matter if Russ is down. Benkai coming back in. It is now map and match point for Global Esports.
Match point. It's not over yet, but what a turnaround for GE. And it just seems like finally it is everything clicking. Right, we constantly talked about the potential, the reads, the plans, the prep.
Yes.
It's all there, but the execution's not. And I'm sure some viewers, they were getting sick of it, right? Because at a certain point, you're like, well, if they can't execute ever, then you know when does it happen? Yeah, then it doesn't matter what prep they have.
I mean,
but at the end of the day, today, not only firing, but it's the positionals, it's the timings, the rotations even on Lotus were very good. Very, very solid match.
It's just, it has been weeks, you know, Will. Global Esports, ever since kickoffs, looking a little bit shaky, but ever so slightly improving again and again.
Hovi gonna peek out with his teammate, has that cover, so he has the confidence to peek out of the screen, and they hold on to yellow. It's already two members down. You still have the operator. B site is locked down, and A, GE doesn't even care about it. They still have the util, and they can go for a retake. They even have the res. They could flood at any point.
And Ben's just watching too. If anyone tries to pull something sneaky, it's not gonna happen. RRQ. Just going forward. That's their only option. Updraft up. And Russ is made aware. They're waiting for that spike tap. To LB Moore as well.
Yeah, I mean Blaze King, he's played alongside some of these guys, obviously. You know, they've been part of the same scene for so long. But what a moment for him as well. A lot of people started to question, where's that fire from Ascension? But it's back.
It is so back. Tell us, Desk, is it back?
I think it definitely is back, especially when now, after so many days of GE fighting, you finally have GE winning, the moment the fans have all been waiting for. I'd say after this, well-deserved indeed.
No, this was a dominant performance on Icebox and a really solid performance on Lotus put together. They looked really good today. They had a lot of really good game plans, especially on Icebox, a lot of trap plays that really caught RRQ completely off guard. It didn't seem like they had great answers behind it. Pulvi had an incredible day. Blaze King had an outstanding day. I mean, just a wonderful, wonderful win for GE.
In just short, everything clicked for GE, right? I was telling you that there was only just one more series where everything is gonna just turn for Global Esports here, and boy, it definitely did on a map as well. Okay, moving away from Ice Master real quick, Lotus, never really expected them to play super well on that map. They really turned heads on that one, and coming into Icebox, did we really, you know, did we really doubt that they're gonna have a not so stellar game? They had an incredible game coming into second map as well.
Yeah, you look at the scoreline, and you know, RRQ, they don't do badly on Icebox, right? We have seen some very good games from RRQ, especially up against, you know, opponents that are perhaps on top of the standings, right? But for RRQ, again, this was them on a day that was very challenging for them, and on a day that everything was just in favor of GE. It was just like, you know, the right place, the right time, the right energy for this team to take the win.
Yeah, and I mean, this is something that's concerning for RRQ, is that we see them come out, look like they can go toe-to-toe with some of the best teams in the world that they have, right? We saw in kickoff against Gen G, where they were pushing them to the absolute limit, just not quite able to beat them. So you got to think, coming into this phase, we're like, okay, now RRQ's had a little bit more time to work on some stuff, get themselves a little bit better fundamentally, get that coordination a little bit more under their belt, and then it just all kinds of, you know, goes away from them today. It just fails them, and that's painful because we had much higher hopes for them. We were hoping to maybe get to finally see them at an international event, and now it's starting to look like that might be out of the cards once again.
Yeah, again, just a couple more matches here, but Global Esports, you know, looking a tad more better, and just to add as well for RRQ, maybe it's because of that 2GE thing. Is Estrella going to come back quickly after that, you know, out of commission day that he has today? We'll have to see.
Yeah, well, we'll have to see indeed, because this, you know, this series is very confusing. I voted for RRQ here, but on our little guess and gain question, I also voted for GE, so it was like, oh, yeah.
Oh, I have no idea. It was all over the place. There was like that classic pistol round win, and then like,
yeah,
I don't know.
And you know, you'd blink and then you'd miss something, and all of a sudden it was like, okay, you know, RRQ is leading, GE is leading as well. But the final answer to our question is that GE leads with 9 pistol kills and RRQ got 1. So let's go over to our board.
Yeah.
And move people up and down accordingly. Who wants to go first? Over here?
Just move me down. I don't really care. this matters a lot less to me than it does.
Okay.
To you.
Well, you know what? I'll join you over here. I get 1.
Yeah.
This is what it feels like to rank up. That's so right.
Yeah, yeah.
So
this,
good, right?
This is the first.
Yeah, feels nice. Feels nice.
Okay. Here you go, Azurai.
Yeah. Finally, after a lose streak.
And you're taking our viewers with us.
Hey, fine.
With you.
You know what? The viewers were always with the hosts. Vic was like side by side with the viewers. Now we're kind of, you know, kind of agreeing with the viewers right now. We're bonding.
Yeah. You are bonding with our viewers. And then
thanks, viewers.
They're getting to believe you, especially with your incredible predictions that somehow come
true. Yeah.
It was incredible, especially since, you know, as we mentioned, everything just felt right for GE. There was also, you know, from RRQ, when you do have that last minute substitution coming in, you kind of wonder as well, like, you know, the rest of the players, all of the other 4 players will need to carry, like, exceptionally well. They can't make any mistakes at all, especially since they're dealing with, you know, a little bit of a disadvantage, right? We didn't exactly see that come online, Clint.
Yeah, it didn't feel like 2GE ever really got comfortable. And part of that is obviously GE's game plan coming in today. It looks like they had a really good read on them. But also, it does hurt you. There is no doubt about that. Still, though, you've got to, you know, play with the cards you're dealt. You can't just come out here and, you know, sneak some cards in and play with jokers. No, you're dealt a hand and you got to work with it. So in that case, you know, yeah, RRQ, it's so hard because I saw a lot of mental mistakes here today. That didn't have anything to do with 2GE as well. Like, using Viper's Pit at really weird times, really weird spots that didn't quite make sense, kind of taking some gambles that I don't think they normally would. It felt like they were on the back foot from the beginning. So I know 2GE didn't play that great today, but I also don't really blame him that much.
Yeah,
I don't really think it was that.
I
don't think it was really the biggest factor.
Yeah, I feel like, at least for me, I feel like I might have overestimated 2GE as well, because I'm a huge fan of what he's done from last year. And of course, him being a Filipino player, I was thinking like, oh, this is another time for, you know, maybe one of the Filipino players to shine right now, but definitely not. It's not here, because it feels like it's too rushed right now for RRQ, especially when, again, it was an emergency as to how he got slotted in.
Yeah, it was, you know, very last minute things. It also is, you know, a test for the team, right? How well can you adapt to this kind of thing? And for GE, for example, they've had to, you know, this whole strategy, this whole new energy that they're bringing, they've had to work with this for a whole week, right? We're seeing the results of it on stage. And of course, it's kind of special as well, like for Blaze King, for example, who has to go up against, you know, on the other side, those former comrades on Bloom Esports, you know, they crossed the ropes together once upon a time. And now, you know, he's on the other side. And you can see how much confidence it actually gave him going up against people that he knew so well.
Oh, yeah. No. He played out of his mind today. He was popping up on stage. I mean, he pulled out the Odin in-game and out-of-game. He was really, really wanting this win big time. I mean, obviously, you do no matter what. But sure, going up against some former teammates, some friends as well. You saw them hugging at the end. So
yes. Clearly,
it's not like there's bad blood or anything. They're friends, but you want to beat your friends. Like, you know, everybody who's competitive definitely wants to be your friends.
Yeah. And this was, I guess, you know, it's special. It's special also, you know, when you're able to be on that stage with your friends, right? Not everybody gets that opportunity. But yes, for RRQ, again, it's a little bit back to the drawing board now because this is revealing some mistakes. As you mentioned, it's not just 2GE, right? There's some mistakes here that go deeper than that. And that might need, you know, an entire period of time to be able to, you know, cure or to be able to workshop once again, much as GE did just a few weeks ago.
It looks like it's the same problems we saw like at times last year where they would talk about the communication wasn't that good and they needed to work on it. And, you know, they're transitioning languages last year to English, you know, so that was causing some dysfunction as well. But now it feels like we're right back to that same kind of issue. Now, again, a lot of credit to GE. Like, there were good util combos and stuff, like the one to get Pulvy up on top of Yellow with the toxic screen and then the snake bite to move Elmimore back on the rope there on B site and keep 2GE isolated. Things like that are really good, but then there isn't, like, protocols and follow-up and, like, communication for RRQ to, like, deal with these situations.
Yeah, and moving forward now, that means that their last match is going to be up against Chen G, the one final match that they have coming in into Split 1 to maybe secure them a spot on
the playoffs.
Of course, right?
Of course it's Chen G.
The big bad boss.
It was written in the stars, right? But for now, we can celebrate the win of Global Esports. We're going to send it to Jen, who is on stage right now with Global Esports. So, hey, Jen, what do you got for us?
Thank you, guys. I am now standing on stage with GE's Blaze King. Now, congratulations, Blaze King. Everyone's been waiting for this win for so long, and you guys were able to get that clean 2-0 against RRQ, the boys you're pretty good friends with. But nevertheless, GE was definitely fighting today. GE was winning today. So how does all of that feel?
Of course, I'm happy to take the first win. Of course, nobody want to lose. They are actually my friends, like really my close friends. So pretty much like 50-50 feelings for me. I feel bad for them to lose, but one of us need to lose. Yeah. So that's the game.
I'm pretty sure they're kind of happy for you, though, to be able to get this win.
I'm not sure.
Oh, you're not sure.
I'm not sure,
okay, yeah. Let's talk about the changes, that for sure, because Finn actually mentioned in the pre-match interview that Benkai will be chipping in. He'll be calling more, taking the role as a secondary caller. So talk to me about why this decision came through and how it works. Who calls what?
I think it's just because, like, our previous loss, we think Ben is not, like, really involved inside the game itself. He just, like, you know, be keep quiet, focus on his aim, and then holding our flank, something like that. So, yeah, we learned from that, and then we want him to actually, like, more vocal inside the round itself. So, yeah, I think it's working out well for us. Yeah.
Now, one of the things that I've noticed is that with this change, everyone's kind of comfortable, and everyone is very just focused on aim, no whiffing, and you guys are hitting heads, hitting shots, right? So how much of this change do you think kind of enabled you guys to pick up this first win? From the player's perspective, do you feel like it's such a huge part in today's win as well?
I think so as well. Of course, if you didn't actually like do a lot of communication itself, you can like focus on aim more, especially it's actually huge for me as well when we actually know what to do in the round itself, so we can just like, you know, execute and focus on the aim. So yeah, I think it's pretty good for us.
Yeah, so everyone's on the same page with Benkai chipping in as the caller, and you know, makes everything easier, right?
Yeah,
so when it comes to the team identity or team play style though, you know, what is the direction that GE wants to head?
I think it's just like play more together and then use a lot of util on them, you know, just bomb them, something like that. Like throw anything, the dog and stuff like that.
And then
we fight together.
Okay.
So I think that's how we're gonna play, because our motto is actually like togetherness as well.
Yeah. I think you just described GE fighting in like longer words. But other than that, you guys are facing PaperX next. Mm-hmm. So anything you want to say to them? They're right there.
I don't know. Maybe have fun.
Have fun. Yeah,
have fun
sure. It's always fun.
Yeah, always fun.
With GE as well. But congratulations once again. And good luck to you in the next matchup. Thank you for the interview. And that was Blaze King with the post-match interview. We're heading off to a short break, but don't go anywhere because we have Team Secret and PaperX facing off very soon. So we'll see you soon.
Okay, Team Secret, we need you guys on the stage now. Come on, let's go.
Right, let's go.
Let's go.
Red Bull gives you wings.
グループ100周年、私たちは愛する立川にかつてないワクワクや感動に出会う場所を作ってきました。そして今大きな夢の実現に挑戦しています。立川と世界を文化、芸術、スポーツでつなぐ、私たちが愛する立川を世界に愛される都市に。立川と世界をつなぐ立ちグループ。
Gives you wings.
Welcome back to VCT Pacific. We are about to get into our second series of the day, Team Secret versus Paper Rex. Let's send it over to Jen to Team Secret to find out how they're feeling about this match.
And today, I'm gonna do the rocking.
Hello, Borkem. Now, you guys are facing Paper Rex. You haven't played them in a while, but you beat them last year. So, how's it gonna go down today?
Like 2-0, because after that, we're gonna go to playoffs.
Okay. 2-0 today, Team Secret in the playoffs. All right, good luck to you. Love the new hair.
Very, very confident predictions from Borkem there. He must be feeling the hair then. It's probably giving him some renewed confidence going into this match.
Sure, why not? I mean, do whatever you got to do to get the wins.
You can get from your hair, right?
Yeah,
why
yeah.
Not?
I don't have any to give him, but he can definitely take whatever I got left. I mean, I Borkem played well against Zeta, by the way. So, like, definitely could be their day. I mean, Team Secret has beaten Paper X before. They know what it's like going up against this roster.
As a curly hair, I also know that it does give you a lot of confidence. It doesn't show because I have a bun, but it definitely does. You know, so looking
Why?
Forward to it. I don't know. It's just because it feels like you look silly, and then if you start not caring, it gives you confidence, and confidence translates into, you know, you just performing better.
Well, you do have something on the other side with Paper Rex, who also does have curly hair. So we're going to send it to Jen to see if something is also feeling that curly hair buff that Azurai is claiming to be. Let's send it back to her to see how they're doing.
Oh, hello, hello, hello. Now, Jing, something popped up on my YouTube algorithm. It said, I will be the first Cloven VCT. Yes?
Of course not. If I do that, I think Alex is going to break the table, so yeah. Definitely not.
Well, then, Alex. Yeah. Yes, Clove?
Why not?
Okay, why not? Today?
Maybe not today.
Okay, maybe not today. Maybe in the finals then. Okay, all right. And hello, Alex.
I mean, I think we have a table or two we can spare, right? Just to see Clove over there.
You know what? Ever since Alex became the table master, I think everyone has like a spare couple of tables just for him.
Yeah. Especially for a match like this, right?
It's built into the VCT Pacific budget now that we have to have tables for Alex.
Yes. The Alex desk. Budget, yeah. Right? There's a few more spare in there just in case we need another one. And as we mentioned, for a match like this, you might need a few more, especially since, you know, we were teasing a little bit. Clove may come out. I actually feel like Paper Rex could be the first team to bring it out. I can definitely see it working on something with how he's been adjusting.
Sure. I mean, there's a couple players who I think could pull it out. I mean, I think something for sure, because Clove plays similar to Reyna in some respects.
Exactly, yeah.
Not exactly the same, obviously, but that's why I think some of the maps that Clove could be good on is the same as Reyna maps. So definitely, or just Forsaken, because he is the master of agents.
Yeah.
I mean, he is a many-faced player in terms of what he can do.
He can't leave like an agent unchecked.
That's correct.
He has to
at some point play every agent there is to complete, you know, his Pokédex of VCT. So absolutely.
Yeah, I like how our talking points right now is, or our graphic right now is saying anxious second place and relaxed second place, because we do
it's
know
how I feel right now.
That Team Secret moving forward still has a lot of ties right behind them on Alpha Group, while Paper Rex, you know that they're just going to breeze through most of their matches just because, you know, they're Paper Rex. So there really is a danger point right now, specifically for Team Secret, that they do need these wins to secure that playoff spot.
Yeah, for sure. And W Gaming is in full swing, right? So, you know, you have Jim back on the roster. They're feeling so good. They're refreshed. They're reinvigorated. But my attention now goes to who on Team Secret can put a stopper to the heavy, oppressive play of, you know, PRX, right? TS will have to rely on their utility, which they are very good at doing, right? So my attention now turns to Borkem, for example, who has played very well. He has that potential to be that, you know, dead stopper for PRX.
Yeah, I mean, definitely your mind drifts to the site anchors first and foremost, Borkem and NDG, mm-hmm. for sure. And then after that, it actually goes to Jesse Vash in his IGLing, in his ability to kind of read the map, play with the map, do the things that worked against Zeta, and really keep Paper X off balance. Now, that's an unbelievably difficult task, but if there's anybody who can do it, it's Jesse, because of his history going up against Paper X so many times in the past. He knows these players, he knows their tendencies, he understands how the brains work, you know, or don't work in the case sometimes of Paper X, or they just turn him off and go. So, but he understands their philosophy, and that's given him some big wins, including last year. Now, that was pre-something, but still, he did get the win over them last year.
One thing I've noticed, you know, with Team Secret is, and this is kind of bad to say, but it feels like when Team Secret don't do amazingly individually, they become an amazing team. Just because you know that their teamwork, the synergy is working well, that they're just a fluid team. That's always what I thought about how Team Secret was. No one needs to go above and beyond compared to like Paper X. So if they can make that happen here right now, there might be a plausible chance coming into the series for, you know, for TS.
I find it also interesting that we're in a series right now with the two rosters that have barely changed, right? You have NDG on the side of Secret. Sure, it's a slight change. I mean, nothing compared to like, you know, other rosters in Pacific, right? And then you have PRX with a re-roster of types. You can't see me right now, but I'm doing air quotes. A re-roster of, you know, of some types, right? But these are two you know, core rosters that have, you know, again, the history between them is very, very extensive. But these are also, you know, two teams that have very, very strong foundations and understandings of each other. So I'm eager to see that in the series.
Yeah, exactly. And I mean, you can see there are two duelists who are topping the charts in a lot of different ways going head to head. So exciting to see Jeremy continuing to have success this year. We know something. He's a given quantity. He's the reigning MVP of Pacific. So for sure, looking forward to that. Looking at the map pool, I don't know. Frankly, like, when I think about Paper X week to week, I'm pretty much just like, yeah, they can play whatever they want, and it'll probably be pretty good. Because like they figure things out so fast. Their time to adapt is so low. I really could see them wanting to lean on anything. And the other side, Team Secret, you know, maybe Split, Icebox. I think those are good choices for them.
Yeah, I feel like, you know, it's for PRX, it's not so much about their map pool, right? It's more of like, you know, that style. And just how well the players of Team Secret are feeling right now. We're going to get into our map picks and bans right now with our IGLs and our coaches. So let's see how this went down.
We'll now begin the map ban for today's second match. A coin toss will be conducted to determine the higher seed. Team Secret is heads and Paper X is tails.
All right, into our map select right now. And we're seeing Warbirds and Jesse Bash and Alex on the side of Paper X. As we mentioned, you know, for TS, I feel like a ban, a bind ban will probably come in just because I think they've been perma-banning that. Yes, indeed, for Team Secret. I feel like for Paper X, maybe a sense.
Breeze.
Okay, Breeze,
there you go. That makes sense, right? Icebox for Team Secret. That's their bread and butter.
Yeah, I was kind of surprised as well that Paper X was willing to ban out Breeze, not Icebox, just because I'd say Team Secret don't really have the best Breeze right now, considering how, again, their sight holds have been kind of questionable moving forward.
They're probably still trying to figure out how to make Raze work on Breeze.
Just for Jig.
Just for Jig. They need time to cook on that one. As good as they are at adapting, they need time to cook.
Yeah, I feel like Icebox Sunset right now. Just thinking about how Jing is able to like utilize the Raze on these maps.
Or maybe a Phoenix.
Or a Phoenix, yeah.
Just saying.
It could work.
I'd like to see it.
Maybe.
I mean, we saw it work kind of for Zeta until
maybe.
It didn't. But it worked good at first.
Yeah. I mean, I definitely see it happening. There's still the question mark of the clove that Jing was probably teasing. So eager to see how this plays out. But right now, I would say brain over heart at the moment. I would say this highly favors Paper X.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, I think Icebox, you're going to get... on this map, but it's been a lot of tightly contested affairs on not just this stage, but going back to kickoff as well, so...
Terium operator or Ion operator aaiye sari.
Operator.
हाँ operator लेता नहीं हूँ ना.
Sentinels of Light Vendel आई है 2100
की. 1700 की हैं दोनों 1700 की.
ऑपरेटर सस्ती आती है.
अब कोई बुलडॉग आएगी तो बुलडॉग लूंगा. 1700 से 2100 के बीच में आई बुलडॉग. फिर स्टिंगर.
एरेस कब लोगे बाबा?
एरेस ले लेंगे. आ जाएगी कोई अच्छी.
मैंने सोचा बाकी का कल्याण हो रहा तो मेरा भी जाए थोड़ा.
एरेस कोई है ही नहीं भाई दूसरी अच्छी
भाई ना. जीत गए भाई जी. आप पेपर एक्स के साथ है उसका नेक्स्ट मैच.
बड़ी मुश्किल से एक गेम जीते भाई इन लोग. आज तो एक तरफा जीत गए.
कल साले वो जो सेकंड मैच था ना व्यक्ति
पूरा देख रहे थे क्या बैठ के?
क्राउड लाइन का. हाँ मैंने तो ऑलमोस्ट पूरा ही देखा जब तक लाइट नहीं चली गई.
अच्छा
मतलब मेरी गई थी लाइट 7:30 के आसपास.
बहुत भयंकर हो गया था क्या?
अबे घंटा पहले ही इसको जीते दूसरा साले वो जीत गए. एक तरफा भाई दोनों मतलब समझ रहे ना. वो सेटिंग नहीं होती जो बैक रूम में वही वाली सेटिंग थी. तीन खिलवाने तो बता दो ना भाई ऐसे.
अबे
लेकिन सेन के साथ तो हुआ नहीं भाई.
मैच फाउंड.
नहीं ये सब लास्ट वाले को साथ करते बाबा.
बड़े मैचेस में होता है ये सब.
हां तो लास्ट वाले के साथ करते हैं. अब इसमें ऐसा था ना बाबा कि अब सबको ही पता था वो दूसरी MIBR करके जो टीम है वो तो वैसे ही नहीं खेलती. अगर उसको 1v1 में जितवा देते एक ये जीते एक वो तो फिर बोल देते लोग स्क्रिप्टेड.
हाँ सही बात.
जो दो टीम अच्छी खेल सकती है उन्हें साथ करते हैं. एक तुम जीतना एक हम जीतेंगे. पार्टी में पैसा आधा आधा.
टॉक कर ले सूरज
एक मिनट.
कितना ऊपर चला गया बे
इस पे.
हाँ सुना
सोना
गोल्ड.
अरे 3-4 कंट्रियों ने वो कर दिया ना अपनी करेंसी बदल के वो कर दी गोल्ड से वैल्यू कैलकुलेट करने लग गया करेंसी की. इसमें से एक वो जिम्बाब्वे वगैरह कौन सी है वो भी है दूसरी भी कुछ अफ्रीकन कंट्रीज है.
इतनी गिरी हालत थी क्या उनकी?
जिम्बाब्वे भी बहुत बुरी हालत थी. बॉम्बे के बाद से उसने चूज के रख दिया है वरना एक टाइम पे सबसे ज्यादा सोने और हीरे वहीं मिलते थे बॉम्बे में. इसने सारा बेच बेच.
अरे अफ्रीका अफ्रीका का एक बहुत बड़ा राजा था ना जिसके पास इतना सोना था कि
बॉम्बे
आधी आधी दुनिया हो जाती भाई.
बॉम्बे था वही कमीना था उसने इतना. अबे लोगों को रोड पे पड़े पड़े वो साइड मिल जाते थे ये हीरे. हीरा था वहां पे आ गया पूरा लोगों को कुछ नहीं दिया वहां की करेंसी सब बर्बाद हो गई. $1 कितने मिलियन डॉलर्स थे वहां के.
पैसा है भाई हर जगह.
मैं तो गया पैसा नहीं है वहां पे गरीबी बहुत ज्यादा थी. मैं तो गया वो ना जिम्बाब्वे गया हूं मैं.
तेरा तो थोड़ा वो फिर भी ठीक ही है मतलब वहां के लोगों में तो अभी भी पैसा नहीं है बस इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर वगैरह थोड़ा ठीक हो गया है.
इंडोनेशिया हो गया यहाँ की हालत बहुत बुरी है. ये लोगों ने बिल्कुल बर्बाद करके रखा हुआ.
इंडोनेशिया की भी हालत खराब है क्या बात कर.
इंडिया का 1 रुपया वहाँ का 173 था जब मैं गया था.
नहीं नहीं आपकी बात कर रहा, अभी फिलहाल पहले तो बहुत बेकार था हर जगह।
हर जगह तो नहीं लेकिन हाँ
वहाँ खासकर था, अब पता नहीं क्या हाल है, मैं गया नहीं हूँ काफी टाइम।
अब तो हर दूसरा आदमी घूमने वाला इंडोनेशिया जाता है भाई, बाली वाली साइड अच्छी होनी चाहिए वहाँ की।
बट वो है कि वहाँ की इकोनॉमी पहले डाउन थी ना, तो वहाँ पे तो डॉलर ही चलते थे, मैं तो डॉलर ही यूज करता था, यूएस डॉलर।
बर्तन धो रहा क्या बैठ के गुरु?
अब खाना खा रहा था, खत्म कर रहा हूँ,
फेंक के आ रहा बर्तन धना दन बना।
अबे चम्मच से पूरा कपा कप
बाकी खा रहा था, चम्मच से
जो सी कटोरी और बची
रोटी खा रहा था चप्पल से।
फिर कैन यू कॉम्बो
इज तेज इधर क्या बोल गए बाबू?
रोटी खा रहा था चम्मच से,
नहीं रोटी खा ली थी, सब्जी बची है, दूध दो, तो एक सब्जी मैंने चम्मच से जल्दी जल्दी खा ली, मतलब पी ली।
विक्की मारेगा
क्या? मारे
मार
क्या?
मारेंगे मारेंगे
रेज, व्हेयर इज योर ग्रेनेड?
इन माय पॉकेट।
समवनस ए, मल्टीपल एनिमीज ए।
किम्बर गया, करी नहीं है।
ग्रेनेड, एनिमी स्पॉटेड ए, बॉम्ब बॉडी आउट। One enemy remaining. Last player standing.
अबे भाई
तू भाई तू वैसे जिंदा ही और रिलोड करता रहेगा भोसड़े के, जब जरूरत पड़ेगी तब कभी रिलोड नहीं रखेगा।
रुक जा
भाग लूं,
रुक जा एक मिनट, सुन नहीं पा रहा हूं
ये साला।
अब ठीक है, अबे नहीं एक्चुअली क्या है, हेडफोन ही दूसरा लगा था ना, मैं समझ नहीं पा रहा बंदा कहां पे, तो मैंने बहुत बुरी चल लगा दिया थी, पहले मार देता हूं।
All be like this with the Razor's life stream sniper.
अबे मैं ले लूँगा, बाबा ही लिखेंगे तो फिर भी समझ में आएगा, मेरे इसमें गेमिंग लिखा है ना।
बी बी
चेंबर की माका
स्पाइक प्लांटेड,
क्या दानन गन कर रहा भाई ये।
लास्ट प्लेयर स्टैंडिंग,
थोड़ा लेफ्ट में दो लोग लिंक में, तीनों वहीं से
तो नहीं आ गए,
तीनों थे वहीं चेंबर में, तो
सुपर से आया थे। और यूज अ गन व्हिचएवर,
अरे 88 साली ये थी, तेज ए पे, ए पे
तेज
वो है ना
आउटसाइड,
मैं ऊपर से आ रहा हूं, मैं तेज ए पे ना, मैं ऊपर आ रहा हूं।
स्पाइक अपने पास ही है,
हां देख ले,
प्ले टुगेदर, प्ले टुगेदर, प्ले टुगेदर।
अब बी से ना आ जा भाई, इस काम करते उसको ले लेने देते स्पाइक, बाद में देख लेंगे।
और हट हट हट,
नीचे आ रहे नीचे आ रहे, स्पीक मत ले मैं लूं। स्पाइक लगाएगा थोड़ी यहाँ, वो लेके जाएगा,
जाएगा
ले गया
अंदर अंदर नीचे नीचे तक ले गया क्या?
हाँ ले गया ना, तेरे को दिखा नहीं ना।
हाँ ले गया ले गया ले गया।
30 seconds left.
तो बी जा, मैं ए जा रहा,
मैं सी जा रहा हूँ।
मेरे पास
आ गई।
10 seconds left.
Satchel out.
गोली मार दे शायद ना देखे।
Satchel out.
टाइम तो पास कर ही दिया था बंदे ने।
की गन उठा पीछे।
This party.
बहुत बढ़िया भाई। क्या ले लो?
अबे मेरा अटक गया गेम।
कोई नहीं गन दे दिया।
मेरी लोड हो गई कान।
मोहन को नहीं आना चाहिए था पगले को।
पगला ऊपर आ गया।
रहना लोटस ने हिल भी नहीं ली थी। मर सकता था।
अरे मेरी गन रिलोड हो गई बे। मोमन को मारा गन रिलोड हो गई बे।
तो गन नहीं ले रहे हो क्या?
पैसा सबके पास कम
है। क्यों जॉय यू एंड मी अंटिल
डे करना है क्या?
टर्न आउट नेक्स्ट
सेज मेरे साइड है।
Out of charges. Reloading.
दो तो मेरे साइड है, दो का नहीं पता।
एक AFK है उनका।
You will not kill my allies.
The outside भी रेस किया।
Caution here.
दरवाजा अल्ट है।
Bring B.
Hey, I'm pissed.
Neon stop. My अबे कवर दे
विक्की। मैं तो हूं ही नहीं तेरे पास।
पट्टी खाई रहना
भाई। उसने अल्ट तोड़ दी सालो। कौन था वहां पे?
वन एनिमी रिमेनिंग।
वहीं था यहीं कहीं था। ये ज्यादा ऊपर से आ सकता है। ए वॉल बना के डिफ्यूज कर। ऊपर देखना है।
लास्ट प्लेयर स्टैंडिंग।
वाह
भाई क्या जूते बनने भाई।
गजब के लौंडे हैं सूरज। कैसे बच्चे पाला बिजली
तू। अल्ट बजानी चाहिए थी। अल्ट भी नहीं बजा पाए वो।
हां अल्ट बजा पाए ना पता पर। तूने अल्ट का लगाई कहां थी?
अरे यहां दबा के लगाई थी ना यहां पे। तो आके मार गया जबकि मेरे पीछे कोई था। टूट गया जहां तक ओमन था।
मैं तो नहीं था भाई। मैं बहुत दूर।
वही वो लकोई तो था मेरे पीछे। तू क्या भाग गया उसको देख के।
You want to play? Let's play.
Either do one. Alright. Spam manna padega bhai.
Bring them down.
Ek bhi ho gaya ek. Plant ho raha.
Spike planted.
स्मोक के अंदर तो था नहीं। इधर बैठा है।
एक तो वो मेरे को पांडा में सब क्यों मुरा पता नहीं भाई। आगे पेल लेता था।
पांडा
तेज और पांडा नला रहना उठे।
पांडा कहाँ है साला?
पांडा नाम है उसका। डब्ल्यूएसएल पांडा।
ये वो क्यों नहीं दिख रहा है?
हाइट कर दिया।
हम हाइट कर लिया।
तो ये विक्की ने किया है जो किया है, मैंने तो कुछ करता ही नहीं हूँ।
अरे
मैंने आराम जादे तूने किया होगा, कौन करेगा।
अभी नहीं होगा, वो गेम के बाद ही होगा।
अभी नहीं होगा लेकिन हो तो जाएगा ना अगली बार के लिए।
ए आ रहा सुन, कॉमन एक के अपना
वन गेस के अंदर भाई। गो गेट हिम सैटल आउट हियर गॉट देम
स्पाइक डाउन ए। अरे ये रहना कहां से आई इसके हरामजादी।
गेट खोल के आ गई साजी, तुरंत रहना लो नहीं ओवर ही लेवल
तेरे सामने जस्ट वैसे आई मालूम।
मारे गा भी तू वॉल बैंक।
लास्ट प्लेयर स्टैंडिंग। अबे यार
किसकी पार्टी में भाई,
इसको रिपोर्ट करो।
कर दिया मैंने, रिपोर्ट करो। कर दिया
They look like us, but are they us? Yeah, no, I just never did. Yes, sir. Yeah.
My ultimate is ready.
Say yes, sir. They were the two games. Phoenix, yes, sir. Phoenix, तू ही बचा है भाई। हम तीन पार्टी में। कोई मतलब नहीं, हम खड़े हो जाएंगे खेलने के लिए।
भाई हम तीन पार्टी में भाई टंकी कर रहा था।
हैकर्स विन।
मेरा वक्त भी ले जा, मेरा शख्स भी ले जा।
रिलिक ऑफ सेंटिनल्स पक्की, दो पिस्तौल आई हैं, इतनी महंगी महंगी लेके क्या करूंगा।
बहुत महंगी आइटम
ये ले लूं क्या, जाने अंडर फैंटम।
फैंटम
और मुझे हार्ट बीट सेंसर लगता है, तो काम की नहीं होगा किसके।
पैसा वेस्ट।
टाइम तो डूब रहा है बाबा भाई।
क्या
मैच फाउंड। तो डूब रहा है बाबा भाई।
कौन डूब रहा है?
चीन चीन
क्या डूब गया मेरे को क्या करना बैंच वाला सीधा अच्छा डूब गया भोखड़ी वाला
ना के गोटे लगे हुए हैं।
मेरा वक्त भी ले जा, मेरा वक्त भी ले।
ले 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 भाई
करेगा।
ये देखो जियोस पता नहीं भाई क्या लोगे आप, वो सोवा लेना चाहती है।
हमें सोवा के अलावा कुछ आता ही नहीं है यहाँ पे खेलना।
लॉक मार दो और के मैं तो बोल रहा लो ऐसे मारते लॉक देखो ये ऐसे बाकी मार के दिखाओ कैसे।
मैं सोच रहा हूँ जेट ले लूं।
क्वाटा पे कभी ना कुछ वाले
वो नहीं ले रहा अब। जस्ट एक सेकंड होने होगा ना भाई उसकी, जस्ट जीरो होने से पहले दबा देना लॉक, उसको कुछ और मिल जाएगा। नहीं तो फिर पता चले उसको मिल गया सोवा और आपको कुछ और मिल जाए, वो भी
नहीं। बाबा भाई को ही मिलेगा सोवा, बाबा भाई ऊपर है ना
पक्का।
हाँ
आज देखते
हैं ये एल्गोरिथम इनका साला सा, जो ऊपर रहता उसको वही मिलता है। देखा
क्या,
जैसे मान ले ओमन भी अगर सोवा लेता तो ओमन को सोवा मिल जाता। हमको शिकारी है।
ले सुरत तेरे लिए क्लासिक ले आया यही है ना म्यूट एक सेकंड में म्यूट
क्या कर दिया
भाई को पता ही नहीं होगा भाई तो पहले करके बैठे हुए
उसने जो ये बकचोदी करी उसकी वजह से मैंने लिख दिया भाई चैट में स्ट्रीम में करने में नहीं करता है बकचोदी तुम्हें नहीं
स्ट्रीम कर रहा है
हां ना
आ गए मेरे साइड
चल 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 चल
भाई कौन है भाई सलाम वालेकुम लिख रहा है मेरे को
कहां पे लिख रहा है
लड़की की आईडी स्पाइक प्लांटेड
रुक यार रुक यार सुरेश
अरे हराम
यार
92 लो है फिनिक्स
Defuse, defuse.
Free for me. But here, I'm at one enemy remaining. Can you pata ekan? Yes.
Mujhe to pata hai na.
Boy.
Ace.
Yehara bol raha hai, Ace maar
raha. Main bol raha tha jaise rok ja manta hi nahi.
बाबाई ने लिखा जी फाइटिंग अरे उसी को चेंज कर दिया अरे
और क्या कंटिन्यू कर दी ना मैंने स्ट्रीम बंद थोड़ी कर जब गेम खत्म होगा तो फिर से वॉच पार्टी शुरू कर देंगे
दो दो स्ट्रीम मार दे रहे हैं आ ये सब ये पर
अबे 55 रेज साइबर की तो बता रही है नियॉन तो क्या नाम है स्काई थ्रो कर रहा है स्पाइक डाउन ए स्पाइक स्पॉटेड ए नीड हीलिंग स्काई एफके भाई रिपोर्ट कर रहा
है कवर देने आओ ना अ फाइन डेथ
वन एनिमी रिमेनिंग नाइस वन
तने खड़ा है देख खेल ले देख देख
भाई हां यही लेफ्ट में आपके स्टैंडिंग अहेड वी लास्ट प्लेयर स्टैंडिंग
क्यों ये खेल रहा है नहीं खेल रहा क्या
नहीं खेल रहा रिपोर्ट कर दो
Engine अभी 4 मैच 30 seconds left. Spike planted. मेरा शॉट्स भी ले जा मेरा नच पहले राउंड में तो
हील भी दे रहा था सबको क्या हो गया अचानक से
इसको अगला राउंड कौन सा राउंड होगा बाप आ गया होगा ना कमरे में संडे है ना आज
वो चूतिया भी नहीं आ रहा भाई
आ गया कब आ रहा है बड़ी बड़ी जीतना है मतलब जीतना है सोचा था भाई मेरे को पहले बता देते कि साला फिनिक्स पास में सो मार देता ट्रस्ट ईच अदर एंड वी विल बी फाइन
टर्न आउट ट्रस्ट इश्यूज प्लेसिंग स्वॉर्म ग्रेनेड
साइफर के ट्रैप ऐसे थे कि मैं नीचे से बैठ के निकल गया मालूम
अभी अभी बैठाएगा वो थोड़ी देर
गोल्डन साइफर
जोक्स ओवर
यू आर डेड एनिमी स्पॉटेड ए टर्न डाउन
नाइंटी खाया है साइफर है ना साइफर 90 है बी जा रहे हैं लोग
बी संभाल बी संभाल मैं देख
मन के पास जा एंटी है सो ये
साइफर इधर ही मेरे पास
एंटी है
मेरे साइड आ गए मेरे साइड आ
गए आ जाऊं
आ जा जा
यार मुझे लग रहा है मिड पे भी आया है कुछ
स्पाइक डाउन
अबे तो चलती है तो संभाल लेगा आ रहा वेट कर
46 और 171 अरे यार 170 तो हील हो गया
बम बढ़िया हील अच्छा वाओ वाओ
ये ना ये
छोड़ क्यों दिया मारना बे उसको
अरे मुझे लगा ओमन भी आ रहा होगा ना टीपी करके इधर-उधर ओमन ने टीपी करा आवाज आई थी
क्या कर रहा है इस फोन पे बैठ के माँ सुधा रहा है या माँ का कस्टमर ढूंढ रहा है हर एक मैच में से झांटू रंडी के पिल्ले आते हैं भाई सीरियस
Don't sit down. We're not done yet.
किसने दिया भाई गाली उसने एक और एस दूं क्या अबे यार ओमन ने टीपी किया कहीं पे
शॉक डॉट बम बढ़िया
आईडिया 46 और 66 है और ये तीन एक का हुआ
स्पाइक डाउन बी
लेफ्ट लेफ्ट
लेफ्ट लेफ्ट लेफ्ट लेफ्ट
लास्ट प्लेयर स्टैंडिंग
अरे राइट में खड़ा है वो पूरा
भाई सरेंडर करो छोड़ो
भाई राइट है माधव
को लेफ्ट लेगा नहीं करेगा थोड़ी वो सरेंडर चार में नहीं होगा भाई
हां हराम हो रहे भाई कौन से रंडी के पिल्ले है पता नहीं भाई सीरियसली गेम को टॉक्सिक बना के छोड़ दिया ये लोगों
जब वो एफ के जाएगा तब देना सरेंडर अभी मत देना नहीं तो फालतू बनो हो जाएगा
किरणडी मां का कस्टमर आया चोद रहा है अभी वो देख रहा है लाइव देख रहा है किरणडी मां
अबे रो यार क्यों क्यों कर रहा है 25 सेकंड मैं भी कम कर देता हूं पता लाइव
लेकर क्या
रिकॉर्डिंग का डोंट
ओवरथिंक इट बहुत ज्यादा है
वीडियो कैप्चर
हाँ बस आधा घंटा तो वो कर रहा होते बच्चों नहीं चल रहे थे आगे चूतिया एक और अबे एक को मार भाई एक भी चले हो
गोलियां काला हो गया जब बाप देख लिया उसको चलाते हो चल दिया
भी जा रहा
है भी
भी भाई भी
सुबह उधर से जा
20 से चले जाओ
प्लान 30 सेकंड्स लेफ्ट
रिवील लेना
रिवीलिंग एरिया
प्रीलोडिंग वन एनिमी रिमेनिंग
दोनों मर जाते
हैं 84 84 टैप
आराम
से
They want to dance? I'll lead.
आज ना छोड़ेंगे तुझे हम मेरे दिल में बजा इसको संभाले नम
प्लेसिंग स्वॉर्म ग्रेनेड टाइम टू हंट
गो वर्ड
अरे मां की चुदन की चलो गए तो
यू आर डेड वॉच देम रन
बेस्ट है ऊपर
एनिमी इन
अरे दो दो पीछे हैं
Bomb grenade out. That's done.
Reload कर. इसके बाद जा जा भाई ये ज़्यादा कुछ कर नहीं पाए.
Last player standing.
27 को बात है.
पच गया.
नाइट नाइट
आई
94 लगी भाई बस
तो
अरे नहीं लगता है भाई शॉट बोल रहा है आवाज उसमें नहीं लगता
है इनको एंटी का तो इशू चल नेट का कुछ इशू आएगा भाई इतना डेप्थ से मार रहा है मरा
बनता ही नहीं है भाई क्या परेशान हो रहा बोलने बनता ही नहीं अरे म्यूट
कर रंडी करंडी का पिल्ला
फिर खड़ा हो गया वो
म्यूट मार भाई मैं तो सोच के खोल दिया चल कुछ होगा
यहाँ का कस्टमर चोट के फाड़ के चला गया ना तेरी माँ को
अबे ये बात तो क्या है इसके साथ
वो कुछ बोल रहा है क्या अभी क्या है
नहीं बस वो साउंड बोर्ड यूज़ कर रहा है ये आईडी वाले नहीं है अभी वाले थैंक यू वाले सब
आ गया भाई
अबे यार एक ट्यूब है सूरज ट्यूब ट्यूब
40 और 50 है पीछे आ गया तेरे पिनेक्स और
सोवा ये रह गया होगा स्काय
प्लेसिंग सेंट्री
मैं गिरा हुआ बंदा जमानी बलिए
री इवैल्यूएट टैक्टिक्स
कवर गोइंग आउट
अलार्म बॉट आउट प्लेसिंग स्वॉर्म ग्रेनेड
डाउन तो है वैसे ना
अबे यार तो वह क्या है मार रहा है हेड
नीचे ले गए हम लोग
अरे एक्सेप्ट आ गए
आ गए भी यार एक मिनट से आ गए हैं ये बैक क्या है सुनो मैं
बाइक
अबे अब क्या बे
अरे यार 148 ओमन पूरा मिड सा है मिड सा है मिड सा है स्पाइक डाउन बी एक मिड पे था ओमन
लास्ट प्लेयर स्टैंडिंग एग्जैक्टली वेयर यू आर
राइट गया 30 सेकंड लेफ्ट यार लग ही नहीं रहा भाई
भाई अबे बंदे ही नहीं बच रहे अपने अपने लगने के छोड़ दे
एवरीवन मेक्स फन ऑफ जर्मन एफिशिएंसी Just keep laughing as you use all my gear. Placing sentry.
Bhai ye hi aa raha hai.
Are aap unke peeche se mat jao bas ye karo pata hai apne side se peeche se ghoom ke travel karo na. Ab unke side se peeche jaoge to wo to milenge. Are bhai peeche jana hi chhod diya bas se main bahut kam jata hu peeche. Sare peeli de dete the.
Placing the knob.
Enemy spotted A.
पड़ेगी भाई।
Enemy spotted A.
अबे ये मेरे पास तो आगे तुम लोग कवर नहीं दे रहे मेरे को भैया।
My ult ready.
ऊपर है 102 रेज। हर बार जैसे खेल रहा भाई, जितना स्काई थ्रो कर रहा उतना ये भी कर रहा साथ में।
Spike planted. One enemy remaining.
Oh
yeah! बच गया भाई।
Hey what the fuck? Soon ball what the fuck?
What the fuck ball तो रहे what the fuck?
What the fuck? क्या दे? My ultimate is ready. The spike is defused. इतना कौन अच्छे दे?
My quiver is never full.
Bro,
what the fuck? What's your shit?
भाई स्ट्रीम छोड़ दे, खेल ले तू पहले।
क्या हो गया, कोई कुछ बोल ले क्या?
ओके okay, आराम वाचिंग।
कौन आप देख भाई? तेरी मम्मी का कौन चल रहा है?
न्यूज़ बोल ले क्या? अभी अभी सुनता हूँ।
भी होगा 100%
enemy spotted A. Spike down A. Enemy spotted A.
पीछे के लो बे। अच्छा वो तो वहां टीपी कर गया, उधर कहां गया?
बी गए लोग।
अरे वो मन देखो कहां है, अभी निकले नहीं उन लोग बी के लिए।
कम से कम दो ही मार दे। दोनों वहीं हैं बे। वो मर गया जो नहीं तो सामने।
It is done.
अबे क्या? थोड़ू चंद। अरे गाड़ी।
मुझे लगा था यही होगा भाई। बाबा जी दबा के उठाते, सूरज एफ दबा के उठाता।
भाई।
वो एफ ना बहुत दूर से काम कर लेता है। हाँ। भागेंगे बे। बी जान जाता है। उमन
उमन है बी पे।
बी साउंड है, बी साउंड,
बी साउंड। नाउ उमन अगर टीपी नहीं करेगा ना तो पाकिस्तान को
नोवेयर टू रन।
दो पीछे उसके।
येलो
गया। अबे
भाई दो मार दिए मैंने, इन लोग पता नहीं क्या कर रहे हैं। तो ओमन के भरोसे मत रहना, तू अकेला है।
30 seconds left.
स्पाइक है उसके पास, छोड़ प्रेशर मत बना। फिनिक्स राइट हो सकता है।
क्या
टाइम पे खेल, टाइम पे खेल, मत तू बच जा बस। तू
10 seconds left.
नहीं होगा, प्लांट नहीं होगा।
एनिमी
ए जा रहा है उस पैक लेके चुकी है
लास्ट प्लेयर स्टैंडिंग
नाइस
भाई 120
आ गया राइट आ गया
लास्ट राउंड बिफोर द स्विच
ये ले
डोंट सेव एनीथिंग
लास्ट ऑन माय ऑन माय वे
डबल क्यों चल रहा है बे चूतिएगा
क्या चल रहा है
लास्ट राउंड है
हां लास्ट राउंड
गायन चाहिए तो मांग लो भाई किसी को चाहिए हो तो क्योंकि गायन चाहिए तेरे को मेरे को नॉर्मल में दिलाते बहुत
मैं गेट अ ड्रॉप थैंक्स
अरे चल जा यार तेरी फटे बड़ी हो
जा मैं तो रैपिड फायर बटन चालू कर दिया था भाई वहां
प्लेसिंग स्वॉर्म ग्रेनेड टर्रेट डिस्ट्रॉयड
स्पाइक
डाउन बी
अरे पीछे आ गया अरे या
वन एनिमी रिमेनिंग
ए स्पाइक
मैं मर गया भाई
वो आ रहा है सामने से आ रहा है चीज आएगा भाई इतनी एक आएगा
ऊपर आ सकता है वो किचन है
एक मिनट ना अभी मैं टैरेट आ जाए या कुछ आ जाए मैं यहीं लगा
दूं टैरेट आने से पहले वो आ जाएगा झांक झांक देखेगा
लेट्स डन क्विक ब्रेक हीलिंग ओवर हियर
लो रख ले भाई इसको ठीक है
last round
switching sides
gun here
gun here
gun here
gun here all gun here
together don't forget that
oh bye bye ye chalaoge nahi wale ye lo
ostadi
sentinels ki hoy sentinels ki lo
na dalle sentinel
are sentinel
ab dalle laudu
साइफर होगा तो रोटेट करना अरे इसकी
मार
रहा हूँ
यार एक बार मार रहा
हूँ
बॉम्ब
बज गया
अबे कहीं ओमन ने टीपी किया भी ऐसा लगा
राइट में
तीनों हैं अबे तेरे नीचे इसका
चले जाओ वो हील दे रहा हील को ले ले
अरे गाइस हील देते
ऑन माय वे आई एम आउट ऑफ स्टफ
मत जाते संधि
नहीं कर देते आई एम आउट ऑफ
स्टफ ये लो है कवर
गोइंग आउट ये गोली में मारेंगे जो
प्लांट द स्पाइक 30 सेकंड्स लेफ्ट
स्पाइक प्लांटेड can't go there
aa gaya
next nahi kar raha nahi kar raha
nahi kar raha nahi kar raha
I think that's it here
kya jaisa kaisa smoke hai
bhai badi der ke baad zeus aaya upar pahunch gaya wo करिए कुछ करिए नस नस मेरी बोले
on my way
आज डूबे या चल मरिए चक दे चक दे इंडिया
मैदान का अच्छी मूवी नहीं है तुरे
भाई मेरे को तो बहुत बढ़िया रिव्यूज मिले उसके
यहां तो फ्री में लगी है मतलब 99 में कोई भी शो
99 में कोई भी शो ना तब भी तेरे को फायदा ही है
अच्छा
कितनी हो गई ज़्यादा 50 से 30 रुपए
अरे बॉडी ब्लॉक कर ले लैंड कर
गया मेरी गन डाले बिकी अरे
नहीं हो
नीचे 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 उमन
उमन ले लो यार बढ़िया
हाथ में देख रहा है उठा बोलता
है
अब इनका बाय राउंड होगा ना तो अपन गन ले क्या करेंगे
अरे अंधा दे दिया मुझे
अरे बहन
जोक्स ओवर यू आर डेड
अबे आ रहा तुम लोग की बजा देगा वो आ जाएगा साले
ओ भाई
ऊपर
अबे लेफ्ट से कैसे मार गया अबे
अबे मैं तीन बंदे मारे लेकिन देखिए मेरे को
तीन
एक अल्ट भी मारी
इनिस का
40 लो है रेजा
ऊपर से एक पीछे से
पीपी किया मैंने
ऊपर वन एनिमी रिमेनिंग ग्रेनेड सैंडल
आउट दैट्स द लाइक
निकाल लेता है यार
अबे डिफेंस में आजकल बहुत ज्यादा आ रहा हूं मैं बहुत ज्यादा करते हैं ट्राई कर नहीं बहुत दिन से नहीं घुसा हाँ थ्रो करके थोड़ा हाथ वो हो गया तंग हो गया
ahead
ye padi
bhai ko mar gaya nahi nahi mara dikha gaya ka acha mar
placing swarm ye lagan chahiye kya placing swarm gone here back up nahi aa raha
reloading are abbe nikle load
गोल्ड के बंदे एकदम अनप्रेडिक्टेबल होते हैं कुछ भी ले लो
भाई
तो पूछ
मेरे पास है मैं
जिंदा है
अच्छा जिंदा क्या ले
ये प्राइम की है ना इसके लिए भी
हाँ
येलो
प्राइम टीम से नहीं कर पा रहे क्या ये लोग
कर ही नहीं रहे हैं कर नहीं पा रहे
तो एक बार फिर से लिख दूंगा
ऊपर आ रहा है 60 लो
बता रहा था मैं अभी भी लौड़े बम
बड़ी आउट बस बोलना होता है
अरे बैक से बैक से बैक से एक और वन मोर बैक से
अब नहीं आ रहा
साउंड नहीं आता क्या
Spikes here.
Packet loss आया हल्का सा 6%
तान चाहिए तो मांग लो मेरे से भाई
रोमन तो जज ही चलाएगा ना उसको दिला के मतलब नहीं मैं जिंदा ही नहीं हूँ हिल ले इससे बस मैं लो नहीं थोड़ी देर वेट करो यहीं लगा दे रिवील मत होना बस जा 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 लगा दे खड़ा है भाई
खड़ा है बेबो
गया ही नहीं वो गया ही नहीं उसको भी लग रहा था शायद यही होगा
हाँ
तो वैन से देख रहा
हूँ साले हो सकता
help a girl out अबे तेरी स्ट्रीम चालू है ना चूती है
अरे वो लोग देख रहे हैं कि नहीं पता नहीं
हम दोनों को कोई नहीं देख रहा है मैं तो नहीं देख रहा बिल्कुल भी तेरी
हाँ तो एक की वाचिंग आ रही सूरत देख रहा है बस
मैं देख रहा हूँ मैं जमा हुआ नहीं
अरे क्या क्या छुटिया बंदी है भाई
चढ़ा है ऊपर
बी पे जा ये पे साइपर है बी पे जा इधर बी पे जा के अल्ट कर दो
क्या करते हैं बंदा है
चारों मिल के जाओ ना भाई काई सुन ले यार
ये जाना जा रहा है भाई अब से वो अबे यार क्या बेतार ही संभालता रह जाऊंगा
अलार्म बॉट आउट
कहां से मार रहे
क्या पता भाई
लास्ट प्लेयर स्टैंडिंग ऊपर बैठा है फिनिक्स नेस्ट पे
कितना ऊपर
फिनिक्स फिनिक्स पे
अपनी गन से मारो यार सबसे बेटर रहता है वेयर वी गोइंग दिस टाइम की गन उठा लो ना क्योंकि खुद तो दिन खराब चल रहे मेरे भी खराब गन हियर
girl out would you bro bahut dhamaki
hai kaise yaar pointer kaun sa hai dekh to rahe londe hawk out left to ultra max
revealing area blinded there they are joke's over you're dead
यो फसा दिया बे इसने कैसे मार दिया रे अबे
ये मेरी हाथ निकल चुकी है गिर ले वन मैच है वन मैच है वन मैच
है हीलिंग ओवर हियर ऊपर खड़ा है बे वो
मार दिया पड़ा है।
कहाँ ऊपर?
येलो के ऊपर। ए भाग भाग तेरे पास एक लेफ्ट।
भाई भाई वो स्मोक
130
तोड़ गया
था।
If you're not a sniper, आ गया। मैंने भी गलती कर दी थी। कौन फेंकना चाहिए था अपना उसके मुंह पे।
गंजी तो कैसा है मेरे को?
शील्ड तो ले ले फिर पैसा है।
Find a weak point and on my way.
Shadows traveling.
यहाँ होता है अक्सर।
अरे यार स्मोक में कुछ भी मार रहा है मादर चो, क्या गेम है रे? क्या करना है? रोटेट या रुकना है? एक्स्ट्रा है?
Take flight.
एक्स्ट्रा
लेने के
खराब कर रहा है। कैमरा
लगा
ऊपर तोड़ दिया।
साइपर
इधर है, साइपर ऐप लगा है, तोड़ दिया। तू
बैक साइड देख रहा है? हां करंट लगा
है। अरे यार
स्पाइक एरिया इज डाउन। अबे 92 तो है। स्पाइक डाउन ए लास्ट प्लेयर स्टैंडिंग। यार विकी इधर राइट में।
अबे यार पीछे वाला मार दिया।
अबे थोड़ा पैसा कर दे।
हां
खेलना पड़ेगा।
ये ओवन मिड पे क्यों जा रहा है समझ में नहीं आ रहा मुझे।
चल बहुत साथ चले।
कहीं मारा है वो मेरे ख्याल से। कहां मारा था वो?
मिड पे मारा था इधर।
मिड चले चले आ
मैं सोवा मिड पे रहता है। सोवा का डाटा तो मैं स्मोक करता है इधर।
अरे भाई आ जाओ फर्स्ट पे। तक
पीछे आ गया उमन।
हेलो हाँ भैया आ गए
क्या? को कवर देके खेल रहे हैं हमारा टीम देखो।
अच्छा आ रहा हूँ। मेरा ऑर्डर आया सुबह मैं आता हूँ लेके। गन पकड़ा देना मेरे को अगर पैसा छोटी मोटी भी चलेगी।
I got the spike.
अबे क्या चूक गया रैंक नहीं बन रहा भाई खेलते।
बंदा मारो बे
140 भी नहीं हुआ वेंच।
मैच पॉइंट
थोड़ा बहुत मारा होता
है। पर पीछे से आके दोनों को मार दिया। मेरे को स्काई दोनों को मार दिया। वी वोंट
लूज। हम क्या करें बच्चों मार दिया तो।
कैसी ना है? हेलो
ऊपर है। हां
Spike down B.
Bomb by yellow. Oh, gande har jagah pe. I have the spike.
Nowhere to run. Spike down.
भाई हर्ट कर ले सोवा करने के जाएगा हर्ट.
Last player standing.
All left.
आराम दो मिनट.
Defenders win.
आ जाओ. आ राउंड से.
मत जमा हुआ बंदा नीश वाली है बाय
नेक्स्ट मैच के बाद में पर थ्री
आ रहे बाय
नेक्स्ट मैच अगर हारे तो सीधे सिल्वर थ्री
कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता हार जाएंगे मत जमा हुआ बंदा नीश मेरा वक्त भी ले जा मेरा शख्स भी ले जा
कांड भी ले जा तेरी घर भी ले जा सब कुछ ले
गलत बात भाई ये सब क्या ऑफर कर रहे हैं आप
तेरी गांड ऑफर कर रहा हूं अपनी थोड़ी
माय गॉड बाबा गलत गलत चीजें ऑफरिंग
अराउंड ओडू
ये चीज इनसे कैसे चलेगा अरे अभी तक आया नहीं अच्छा ये तो कुछ करने गया था
कहो न कहो ये आके बोलती है ओ सनम ओ मेरे सनम कहो न कहो ये आके बोलती है ओ सनम ओ मेरे सनम वक्त में भी बस तेरा सहारा है बादलों से ऊंची उड़ान उनकी सबसे अलग पहचान उनकी तुझसे है प्यार की कहानी मंजूर आते जाते दिल की रवानी मंजूर
कौन लीडर है भाई
विकी आई है
क्या खोल के चेक करने चले गए कैसा लग रहा ऑर्डर
मैं तेरे कदमों में रख दूं ये जहां तेरी अम्मा की ऐसी तेजी
क्या गाने गा तो जैसे ही लगता
आँखों में कजरा बालों में कजरा तू लगा के आई यूं घूर के मर में क्या ताड़ के
cannot enter matchmaking क्यों आ रहा है
बाहर आ
गया क्या
हैं
बाहर है
तू है ही नहीं तू कहाँ है
देख नहीं रहा क्या मैं
नहीं अभी तेरा नेट गया था
अच्छा स्ट्रीम चालू है बंद हो गई
चल रही है
रुक जा
अबे क्या थोड़े से हो क्या भाई तुम क्या कर रहे
हो भाई अब धोखे से वो हो गया मेरे को एक बंदे को धोखे से वो वाला इनवाइट भेज दिया मैंने
अरे
आ रहा हूँ यही हूँ
मैं
मेरे को अपने लैपटॉप के ऊपर एसी चलाना, ये कूलर चला के रखना पड़ता है, डायरेक्ट हीट हवा तब निकलता है।
सेम सेम
ऐसा गर्म, ऐसा कि कोई हिसाब नहीं साला।
सेम है रोहन।
मी लाफिंग इन कॉर्नर।
मी लाफिंग इन कॉर्नर, तेरा कोई काम क्या है भोसड़ी के, ना स्ट्रीम करता है ना कुछ करता है, तू पीसी बनवा के तूने अपनी गांड में डलवा लिया क्या भोसड़ी के लौड़े बेटी चोद।
क्लिप
अभी अभी दबाया मैंने क्लिप की बटन, क्लिप, अभी दबाया। हां
क्लिप दबाने आया मैं दूर से।
चुतिया पता नहीं क्या पीसी बनवा के बैठा है, टेरिटी ले लो, ये ले लो, वो ले लो, भोसड़ी का चला करेगा तो है नहीं स्ट्रीम।
क्लिप
कौन साला,
क्लिप भाई क्लिप सब क्लिप।
वो
नहीं ले पा रहा, ये
ना
पेमेंट नहीं आ पा रही, भोजली वाले बस बोल रहे हैं सर 21 दिन ज्यादा हो गया तब भी नहीं देंगे हम आपको पेमेंट।
हाँ इसके पहले तो कभी आई नहीं ना पेमेंट, सूरज खाते में जीरो है।
इसके पहले तो हम तुमको भी तो बोल रहे हैं, तुम तो बोल रहे अगली आने दो है, तुम भी तो दे चले लो
ना भोसड़ी के, उसका और तेरे इनकम में बहुत फर्क है चूतिए।
अच्छा
चलो भाई
बिल्कुल
कंट्रोलर,
लाखों में कमाने वाला महीने का बेचारा, वो हजारों में कमाने वाला
भाई, वो दिन गए,
वो जमाने गए,
कब रहे
पे वो गए जमाने गए, वो जमाने गए, लाखों में कमाना अभी अभी ऑलमोस्ट सब सेम लेवल पे
आएगा, सेम लेवल पे। तू साले अपने एक शेयर बेचेगा किसी का ना तो तेरे को उससे दूना पैसा मिल जाएगा इन्वर्टर से, ठीक है ना।
हाँ तो वो तो पता है मुझे,
फिर
एक एक बजाज, एक बजाज शेयर भी बेचूंगा ना तब भी मेरे 2000 रुपए बच जाएंगे।
फिर है अभी तेरा पोर्टफोलियो टोटल
है, मेरा पोर्टफोलियो ज्यादा नहीं है भाई, मतलब 4.5 कुछ का सिर्फ उस पे है स्टॉक पे सर, और उस पे मुझे अभी 1,20,000 के ऊपर का फायदा है, मतलब 5-5.5 लाख कुछ हो रहा है टोटल।
देखो
6,000 का इन्वर्टर नहीं ले पा रहा।
हां और ग्रो पे 1.5 लाख कुछ डले हैं सिर्फ स्टॉक, सॉरी स्टॉक बोल रहा, म्यूचुअल फंड पे, और 30,000 कुछ के स्टॉक्स होंगे जो गवर्नमेंट वाले हैं जिनका मेरे को ज्यादा काम नहीं है।
दिस बो हैज टेस्टमेंट एंड 8 लाख की आसामी यही बैठी है, देख रहे हो ना, देख रहे हो ना विनोद, 8 लाख की आसामी बैठी है,
थोड़े थोड़े पेटीएम में डले हुए ज्यादा नहीं, 70-80 हज़ार के ऊपर
ये लोगो, 9 लाख की आसामी बैठी है बेटा, 10 लाख की आसामी
और 1-1.5 लाख कई जगह पे डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड है, तो ज्यादा कुछ नहीं बोलूंगा।
अबे ये तू
आउट ऑफ चार्जेस,
चार्ज आउट
चूतिया। हेलो
हां जी,
मैंने मैंने बोला आजम को तूने ये सब चीजें क्यों नहीं सिखाई।
अरे यार कितनी बार बोलना,
बहुत बार सिखाया भाई, बहुत बार
भाई विक्की से पूछ लो अगर मैंने कभी उसको कोई चीज ना सिखाई हो ना बताई हो, या मैं कभी आके ना बोला कि चल मैं करके बता देता हूं भाई, सीन वही है ना, बंदे के अंदर करने का विलिंगनेस होना चाहिए, बात यही है और कुछ नहीं है।
ये आ गए,
वो लोडू करता ही नहीं है कुछ।
Smoke's down.
Gotcha. That body block pass kar bhai,
spike down A.
Spike chula mai bas.
Launching smoke.
Andar
ja,
ho jaye, heal ho
jaye. 1 TP hookah. Chhod spike hai na.
Spike here. Acha spike
hai. Main to chilla raha hu itni der se.
वो आएगा पीछे से, वो चला गया अंदर।
One enemy remaining.
मेन मेन मेन।
अरे सुबह भैया।
ब्रेम आराम से ले
लो। Last player standing.
लैम सर।
कट्टा नहीं पड़ा भाई।
नहीं। अबे तूने स्मोक लिया है?
अरे उसने एंड टाइम पे आईसो बदल लिया ना साले।
इसको ये घूमे जा रहा है सर।
माइक नहीं है भाई उसके पास, बोल नहीं पाएगा कुछ ना वो।
भाई उसने इंस्टेंट लॉक कर दिया
भाई, तो बच्चे होते हैं छोटे छोटे।
क्या हो गया, कौन रो दिया?
जेट
क्या हो गया?
और कुछ नहीं रहा, खेल ही नहीं रहा, खड़ा
बी बी बी।
अबे ए पर भी दो भाई,
मुझे
स्मोक चाहिए तो बता देना,
स्मोक देना तो
एक ही तरफ की मिलेगी
अभी। लॉन्चिंग स्मोक,
पूरी नहीं मिल पाएगी उधर, इधर से वो नहीं आता।
इससे यहाँ खड़ा हुआ कर।
अच्छा इधर
स्पाइक डाउन बी।
अरे तुम्हारी है।
अबे कहाँ गिरा दिया मेरे को, मार रहे क्या साले?
एक ऊपर भाई, एक ऊपर भी है
भाई साहब, अंदर गया था
पीछे
चल रहा था ना
तो ये
तब
क्यों नहीं आते जब वो करते हैं? चलो क्या पता भाई,
जेट लेने वाला
था क्या? नहीं बिना बताए
पड़ा
ही नहीं बस 40 गेको योरू 40 लैम्प्स में ये डस्टबिन का वो तो देख क्रॉस है
मैं इसके अंधे
ये योरू के लिए रुका रह जाएगा और गेम निकल जाएगा पूरा
राइट राइट राइट
प्लेयर स्टैंडिंग भाई ये क्या है यार बार बार जेट इंस्टेंट लॉक और किया है इसने
रिपोर्ट कर रिपोर्ट तो कर बहन के लौड़े को
कर दिया भाई रिपोर्ट कर दिया कर दिया वो एफ2 रिकनेक्ट हो तो गया वैसे वो
उल्टा मुड़ गया ना ये।
Watch them run when lit by my sonar. That's when we strike.
₹50 पे गांड पे
बाप को बोल रिपोर्ट करने
झोंक झोंक अभी देता हूँ।
अरे अरे आ गया
आ गया फिर रिपोर्ट करने के नाम से आ गया।
स्कैनिंग अहेड, देयर दे आर।
लॉन्चिंग स्मोक,
मल्टीपल एंड ब्लॉकिंग साइट, ब्लॉकिंग साइट
मॉली।
ना ना
ना 75 खाइए रहना।
That's stim beacon here.
Spike planted. One enemy remaining.
मत लगा मत लगा मत लगा। इधर गई।
Nice one, Brim.
कर लेते मेरा तो alt है, तेरा भी है बस।
मेरे आने से मेरा नहीं है alt.
करना भी देता।
आ जाओ आ जाओ।
रहना 75 खाई थी बैच।
अरे भाई
चल बक
थोड़ी दिल लग रही।
थैंक यू
हो सकता है।
भी हो सकता है
मिड पे खड़े हो। हाँ यहीं पे खड़े हो, यहीं से आते दोनों साइड का।
भी हो सकता है देख कैड बनने जा रहा है
क्या? करूं क्या स्मोक बताना?
वहीं रहो वहीं रहो वहीं रहो वहीं रहो
स्टे
गधा
स्मोक करूं क्या सूरज?
अरे अपने ये जा
आकर
अब वैसे है
स्मोक
नीचे कर दे ऊपर नहीं करिए अभी
ठीक ठीक अरे ऊपर है बंदा
लॉन्चिंग स्मोक
ये जाएंगे वो
हां ब्रो मैं यहीं से आएगा
आगे
ये जा ये जा
अबे कुतियो
लैम्स में बैठा भाई वो कैंप करके
सूरज क्या सीन है
ऑफ योर फीट
इधर नहीं बार बात
एक वहीं पे कर गया
30 सेकंड्स लेफ्ट
आ जा प्लांट होता
दो बंदे निपटाते भाई अगर मजा
आ लॉन्चिंग स्मोक डैम
स्पाइक प्लांटेड
Now
or never. Load kar, load kar,
load kar. Lamp se,
Niklega bahar.
Last player standing.
Abhi long pe hai. Jaa dip to baith, dip to baith ja. Ab nahi aayega.
Aadha kar dunga.
Clutch. Arre.
Mere time pe saala khade hi reh gaya yaar.
अबे लैंप्स लैंप्स का कॉल देता रहेगा नहीं तो पता होता तो वहां से उधर से टावर देता
तभी तो मैं बोला क्या आया था अलार्म बोर्ड अपना लैंप्स तो आएगा नहीं
हम
तो सामने पता नहीं कहां से आया सामने देख लेना चाहिए
इक्के यहां खड़े हो
हां हां भूल जाता हूं बार-बार
क्या भाई बोलो वहां खड़े हो
भाई एक्सपर्ट भाई एक्सपर्ट है उसी
में दोनों साइड का मिल जाता है कवर ना फटाक से 1 सेकंड में दोनों साइड आ जाएगा
स्मोक के लिए कॉल दे देना
Who's next?
No way! No run! Who run?
Smoke down.
भागते रहे भागते रहे भाई रुकियो मत
मेरे पास
Smoke down.
बुला लेना
मुझे टारगेट कर रहे थे एक भी नहीं लगी
नहीं
नहीं
launching smoke
ek hi smoke tha suraj kar diya
molly
landing
no distraction
idhar idhar
wo le gaya
spike planted
multiple enemies b
one enemy remaining
हट 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 छोड़ 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 छोड़
इतना हो रहा भाई यार क्या
है बेल्ट आ गई ना मेरी
ठीक है
एवरीवन नोट डाउन योर ऑब्जर्वेशंस देन लेट्स रन इट अगेन
ठीक है अच्छी लगती है ठीक है सारे
कौन सी
व्हाइट कलर वाली कर रहे हैं ऑरेंज व्हाइट
ऑरेंज
वाइट टाइपिंग चल रही है बॉस
उन दो अपने लिए फायदेमंद
भी आएंगे जब से अगर सुन टाइप के बस प्लेट आएंगे
वन मोर
टीपी करके
टेलीपोर्टर के बाहर ही है
लॉन्चिंग स्मोक
ब्रीच था हुका
ये
चले गए जेट वोट भाई गेम खेलना छोड़ दे भाई जेट
स्पाइक प्लांटेड अरे 40 खाया सोवा 70 है ये
40 का डैमेज दिए सिर्फ
थोड़ा जा रहा
अबे यहां से आ गया
चूतिए वहां से आ गया तो कवर तो दे
90 अबे वो डब्बे पीछे था 91 पड़ी उसको डब्बे पीछे था
मारा था भाई
बोन एरो इज ओल्ड फैशन समटाइम्स ओल्ड वेज इज बेस्ट
क्या कर रहे हो भाइयों
जेड भाई ने इतनी स्पीड से लॉक किया था उतनी स्पीड से मार
भाई भाई आप जेड का एम देखते ना अभी आप कह देते भाई छोड़ दे जैसा कि मैंने कहा
अरे क्या बात है
ओनली इंस्टा लॉक रिफ्लेक्सेस ब्रो
तुझे आप आप कर रहा है उससे लग रहा
है मुझे भी एम कर
रहा है स्मोक्स डाउन अरे डर जा रहे हैं नाइस
फोकसिंग बुला लेना
किधर से टार्ट डाउन हुआ
लॉन्चिंग स्मोक
प्लांटिंग हुई
प्लांटिंग
प्लांट
प्लांटिंग आवला जल्दी एक अंदर है दो तो अंदर है रीलोडिंग
हवा में कैसे मार देता है
दोनों दोनों साइड है दोनों साइड है
ओके ही है यार ये सच में
सही में
शूट द बैड गाइस हाउ इज दैट फॉर अ प्ले
ब्रेम भाई बाय मांग लेता हूं मुझसे भाई अपन दोनों ही खेल रहे हैं
नहीं ठीक है भाई
हां
हां भाई मांग लेता तो अभी कैसे भाई करता फिर
इट गॉट नर्व
ऑल टाइम उस पे लोकेशन बताना मुझे कहां है
स्मोक चाहिए सर
पता नहीं यार अभी तो कुछ
गए भाग गए वो यहां से
आजा स्मोक दे
स्मोक डाउन
अरे अपना बंदा किया
नहीं रहना भी वहीं था
अरे मेरे पास रहना गुड
गन हियर रीलोडिंग राइट हियर
यू विल नॉट किल माय अलाइज
वो काम आ रहा था
ये बेस्ट डाउन
launching smoke
are mid
bhi hota hai isme apna
abhi
molly
one enemy remaining
spike are kahan se aa gaya sala yoru
30 seconds left
ha yoru wahi hai
bhai kahan ye pada
pura samne
abhi ja raha hu
nahi nahi bhai hai
bhai hum log
could have predicted this all right I did
they demand a fight who are we to this
reloading
aur ye rehna ye bottom pe chal rahi hai unka wo chal raha hai brimstone ye kya naam hai sale ka
bhai unke se do maar raha sirf do
each
बैटमैन सोवा ब्रीच और सोवा बस देयर दे आर
लॉन्चिंग स्मोक इधर मेरे कीबोर्ड का टी खराब हो गया भाई
डी
करते ऊपर से
दे रहा
स्मोक्स डाउन
कंप्लीट कर दे।
अबे क्या फेक अल्टी है चूतिया जैसे। प्लांट हो गया भाई यहाँ पे बता रहा हूँ।
भाई इसके ब्लाइंड भाई कितने।
अगर प्लांट हो रहा है तो मुझे बोल दिया
था।
यार फ्लैश के चक्कर में मर गया वो।
यूरो है लैंप का।
लास्ट प्लेयर स्टैंडिंग। अबे ये यूरो कहाँ से आ
गया?
भाई मेरे पे दो बंदे चढ़े हुए थे मैं क्या करूं?
अरे तो मुंह से बोल जाना भाई वैसे थोड़ा ना बोलना। हाथ से मैं तो नहीं हाथ से बोल रहा।
आप करके बात कर रहा है।
अबे तो भाई तो मैंने गाली तो दी नहीं ना भाई।
Who's next? Launching smoke.
Now why who's next?
नहीं बात।
Launching smoke.
जेट उसकी आगे चली गई तो मतलब कोई आएगा तो नहीं
वहां से।
मॉली
आता
है वो पीछे।
अरे यार
इधर इधर
इधर।
वन एनिमी रिमेनिंग।
नाइस
स्पाइक डाउन बी।
हां ये चुन स्पाइक
है। ओके एफ को मार दे भाई। किल ले ले जल्दी जल्दी जल्दी।
के लिए पक्का इसने ट्रिगर बॉट लगाया नहीं तो वो भी ना हो पाए।
ये ले
है मेरे पास जिंदा
भाई
भाई भाई
बढ़िया है। 5v4 है जल्दी जल्दी खत्म करते हैं।
बड़े अच्छे से यूरो अल्ट करके आया चूतिया। अरे पीछे और मैं डेज हूँ तभी मार दिया साले को चूतिया को। ये दोनों खेल रहे हैं बस मानो ऊपर के दो बाकी।
हाँ उनके यहाँ पे वही दो हैं बस।
बैड मैन
शेट
नो डिस्ट्रैक्शन स्मोक्स डाउन
फाइव है।
स्पाइक डाउन बी
ओपन अप द स्काई
एडी
सोल्जर
आ रहा हूँ बे। कहाँ है स्पाइक बता? वो लॉन्ग पे है क्या? मत मत ले भाई मत ले। हाँ ले रहन जाल ने जाल।
अबे
यार
स्मोक डाउन
स्पाइक स्पॉटेड बी
ये पे ही है।
धीरे धीरे स्पाइक अभी मेरे पास
आ रहा हूँ
भाई। केजे पे स्पाइक है जल्दी जाओ।
लॉन्ग का क्यों है पता नहीं कहाँ होगा।
ब्रह्म भाई तुझे जाना पड़ेगा मेन।
वन एनिमी रिमेनिंग।
नहीं बता गाना। एफ के भाई चिया।
अरे वो साला चला है। एफ के नहीं है वो।
वो उधर से घूम के आएगा।
अरे नहीं यहाँ पड़ी थी ऑपरेटर।
अरे अरे।
Switching sides. I'm amped. Let's go. I got things to do.
अगले
अबे तो रेगुलर प्लेयर्स का ऐसा थोड़ी को मतलब होता है कि बेंचो जो हफ्ते में एक बार खेलते हैं उनसे ऊपर ना जाए। जानते हो ना
क्या बोल रहा है सुनने दो भाई। क्या भाई
शील्ड खरीदूं वो ब्लॉक कर दी है बुलेट
खरीद ले। एक शील्ड ले ले। एक शील्ड तो मिलती है ना।
हाँ
एक शील्ड ले ले एक वल्नरेबल ले ले।
अच्छा
अभी तेरी सब बात मानेगा तू ऊपर है ना भाई।
अबे कोचिंग शुरू कर दूं क्या मैं छोटे लड़के
को? ये मुझे रिवर दो ना।
ले भाई रिवर ले ले वो कर रहा हूं।
लॉन्चिंग स्मोक। लॉन्चिंग स्मोक।
अबे ये जज ले खड़ा है मतलब जल्दी
शॉट डॉट
भाई
साठ लो है ब्रीच जेट ने दिया
क्यों करना है भाई सरेंडर
जेट ने दिया मुझे लग रहा
मैंने एस कर दिया भाई
मैंने भी एस कर दिया अरे यार किसने नो किया
आई सुन
टेक देम वन बाय वन ओने भाई ये 27 कहां गए भाई प्लस 27 कोल्ड
प्लस 27
वॉल के ऊपर होगा
अबे वो इंटरनेट वो है क्या बोलते हैं
ये कंट्री का तो होगा
इंटरनेट कॉलिंग करते हैं ना तो वो फेक आईपी आती है अरे मार दिया मेरे को बे मेरे को लंका डाल दी
क्या था उसके पास
अरे ये था साला के पास उसके पास
अबे यार 105 ब्रिज सूरज गाने उस पे मरेगा तो अबे सामान ही लगाता रहेगा अबे
सामान लगाते नहीं लगा जैसे वो हुआ ना पहले उन्होंने देखा नहीं था मैं हूं अभी भी रिवील हुआ मैं तो साले देख लिया
तेरे को रिवील तोड़ना चाहिए था ना पहले सामान ही लगा ब्रिज ने 105 मारा है मुझे नहीं 104 मारा है तो मैंने 105 मारा है
उन पे कोई भी इनिशिएटर नहीं है अपन घुस तो सकते हैं आराम से
अरे तो अपना वाला तो नहीं घुस रहा ना
भाई अपने दो ड्यूलिस्ट हैं मैं तो खेल रहा हूं चलो सब पता नहीं क्या होगा
जेट तो वाला बहुत गन में भी है
जेट भाई हम पे मेहरबानी नहीं करी पर आगे से इंस्टॉल लॉक मत करना दूसरों में मेहरबानी कर देना
Standing ahead. Stim beacon down. Found. Enemy lead. Enemy spotted. Enemy sentry.
Destabilizing. Enemy spotted. Launching smoke. Reloading. Reload.
Holly. Making cover. One back spike.
आ जाओ ना प्लांट करो ना भाई
आए तो तेरे पास ही है भाई स्पाइक
Nowhere
to run. अरे भाई कर देना.
Spike down. अबे क्या मार रहा है बे? Smoke down. बैठ जा तू. ऊपर एक बंदा. Got the spike.
ऊपर पीछे से होगा ध्यान.
दो है. One
enemy remaining. मैं कवर में लो मत थोड़ा दो.
वाग मार दो
अरे नहीं हो रहा क्यों लिख रहा है भाई क्यों कौन लिख रहा है आई गॉट
योर बैक ये ले भी अपनी गन तेरी
अरे 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 उसे जज मारी भाई गन पकड़ ले आई नीड
अ गन बाय देना ब्रेम
आओ तो सालो
एक तो पता नहीं है तेज भड़वा जब भी देखो शॉटगन लेकर मुंह
पे हमारा लेके जा
क्या सामान अरे यार
आई नीड अ गन दिलाना भाई ये इधर दिलाना थैंक यू प्लेसिंग अलार्म बॉट रिवीलिंग एरिया
रीलोड मॉले एनिमी स्पॉटेड ए आवडन कर रहा
है क्या
हां
बिग कैसे
वाचिंग स्मोक अरे एनिमी
स्पॉटेड ए भागन दो
बैक स्टेप अबे यार बैकस्टेप कैसी की तैसी वाली
यार
फोकसिंग तुम्हें उनको पता है पोजीशन तुम लोग कैसे होल्ड कर रहे हो
standing.
100 low hai breach.
Spike down A.
Aur 30 low hai Sova. The Sova to mil gaya usko.
Not bad. Got the spike.
Left, left, long.
Destabilize. Breaking them.
चलाता हूँ आ रहा तो भाई दमना
है
remember to talk to each other out there we communicate win
ये कुछ नहीं बोल रहा
क्योंकि
Let us hunt.
Stand it.
Revealing the beacon here. There they are.
Enemy spotted.
No distraction.
यहीं कहीं गया है? रोक ना होल्ड करना. मार दिया.
Launching
smoke. Yeah.
भाई मार लो ना साथ में तेज है अब स्पैम नहीं कर पा रहा
तू कौन है अबे तू शांत रहेगा तू
ऐसे ओए प्लांट कर पता नहीं कहां है ये
ओडिन उठाओ ओडिन उठाओ ओडिन उठाओ
कहां है ओडिन नहीं दिख रही नहीं दिख रही उसके बाद
इतना रो रहा है स्पैम के चक्कर में अंडू मारा उसको तो चालीस भग गई टीटी करके
जेट भाई वायर कर दे
ड्रॉप दे ड्रॉप दे
भाई सोवा को कुछ तो बोलो भाई
सोवा
को कुछ
तो बोलो बोलता है ब्रेकिंग देम स्टॉपिंग फायर स्मोक्स डाउन एनिमी स्पॉटेड ए
The hunt begins.
Ollie. Then begin here. Jackass.
TP kar.
Reloading.
Dekh ke jana.
Placing swarm grenade.
Haan, kar ja 10
minute. Down.
Ult pe le sakta hai kya?
निकल जल्दी वहां से
प्लेसिंग सेंट्री
स्कैनिंग अहेड
इनिशिएटेड
एक ए पे ही है अभी चूतिया गोली चला रहा दन 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 सेज 40
एल्बो एल्बो योरो एल्बो है साइट है साइट
है
माइंस ऊपर ही उड़ रहा है
राइट हियर आई विल टीच हिम टू रिस्पेक्ट देयर एल्डर
बाबा भाई को तो ओडिन दिया था कहां गए ओडिन
नीड अ ड्रॉप ओवर
देयर
अरे उसको ये लो अरे पापा मेरे को देख रहे थे जेट सामने आ गए जेट में चले गए
भाई स्किन दियो अपनी ब्रेम
ये भाई परेशान मत हो
शो मी अ टारगेट डी स्टेबलाइज
रिवीलिंग एरिया
स्टॉपिंग फायर
लॉन्चिंग स्मोक
और देन
स्मोक डाउन
लवड़ा क्या तूने मारी गोली भुसड़ी के जो बोल रहा लवड़ा
अरे तो मैं मर गया ना लवड़ा बोल
लवड़ा तू ऐसा बोल ना लवड़ा मैं ऐसा बोल
लवड़ा थी भाई, ये तो आसान था, ये तो आसान था।
शील्ड भी थी इसके पास वो वाली डबल टैप।
हां आसान था ये, दो बार में भी नहीं मारा था ना उसकी रेस से।
तीन हरा है रहा
सो बात बहुत।
बाकी ये दोनों लो थे इधर।
अबे मैंने एक
सोवा नहीं था, आई नीड अ गन।
सोवा को मैंने 103 मारा था
भाई। देना
दे दे भाई,
भाई दे दे। ले भाई
सब ले ले। पूरा ले दूंगा नहीं साले को।
बी पुश करना पड़ेगा।
बी निकलता है ना अपना।
टुगेदर
मुझे ये और दिलाओ, मेरी भी अल्ट आ जाएगी।
उठा लेना किसी। स्टिम बीकन डाउन।
तू आगे जा, मैं देख लूँ
कहाँ करूँ अल्ट।
कहीं कहाँ लेफ्ट गई राइट गई।
अच्छा वो उसको देख रहा था जेट।
जेन के पीछे है।
के पास में कोई नहीं।
डिस्ट्रैक्शन खाली हो। जाओ पुश कर रहा
हूं। लॉन्चिंग स्मोक।
मर गया।
ऑफ योर फीट।
लास्ट प्लेयर स्टैंडिंग। ये उसको पिस्तौल
से पहले
स्पाइक डाउन बी।
81 था भाई ब्रिमब्रिज।
I didn't bring a snack. Did anyone bring a snack?
सेव निकाल लो भाई ये राउंड। या फिर सोभा भाई, सोभा भाई अपनी गन बेचकर ब्रेम को भाई देते
हैं। अरे रहने दे भाई,
राउंड ले लेंगे।
इधर वो गंजी तो मांग ले मैं
भाई। उस सोवा को तो कुछ तो बोल, मेरे को बोले जा रहा है 3 किल पे अटक गया।
उसने इंशाल्लाह तोड़ी क्या भाई।
टेकन डाउन।
उसने इंशाल्लाह क्या था उसको बोलते फिर क्यों भाई। सुरे
मार तो दे अब। स्मोक डाउन।
ये टीपी क्या कोई?
भाई आपके पीछे।
ते बोल नहीं चाहिए?
अरे।
चल अंदर चल। अबे यार भाई जेड भाई क्या कर रहा है?
134 है। ऊपर 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 ऊपर।
एक ऊपर एक नीचे। भाई जेट ने क्या चुतियापा किया है बे।
जेट फेस को ना पलटा सकती थी, बहुत लंबा
था
उसका
मान निकल। सेज को मार दिया तो निकल गया उधर। राउंड एक तो ये सेज वॉल कर देती है ना यहाँ पे इंस्टेंट।
तोड़ दो ना।
ये देखो जॉय बॉय को
अपने। भाई तेरा जिंदगी में योगदान है कुछ?
तोड़ भाई इसको। अबे यार अपन जाएंगे वो फ्लैश देगा।
मैं जा रहा
हूँ रुक। मैं नहीं
चल साथ ऊपर। ये है ना सेज।
Open up the sky.
पूरे मैं बहुत लूँ।
हमारे टीम में
चूतिया
भाई यार कॉमेडी एट पीक
मैं अटक गया हूं मैं टीम के बाद मारी नहीं पा रहा
सूरज पैसा है क्या
हां बहुत पैसा वो तो ले लिया
नीड इक्विपमेंट थैंक्स
डीप ब्रेथ
बोल भाईरा
अबे यार ये जेट को बोले तो क्या बना करे भाई
टच आउट
स्टिम बीकन हियर
भाई गेम ऑन यू ब्रो तो वाह भाई गेम छोड़ दो
तू छोड़ देना लवड़े
बड़वे तुझसे ऊपर हूं
मां को क्या करना है भाई तो मां से तू का काम कर
बड़वे इधर आ तू 1v1 में स्पैम करता रहता सारा
मैं पबजी वाला नहीं प्ले तू 1v1 करेगा
आना तेरी माँ के साथ भी क्या
था तेरी
मम्मी के साथ भी बनने वाले क्या था
मर रहा हूँ अकेले अकेले सबके सामने
ऊपर स्मोक दे रहा हूँ मैं कहाँ दूँ स्मोक ऊपर देख खड़ा है अपना बंदा
कवर दे अरे
कवर देने कहां आ रहा
है हो गया जी जी लास्ट प्लेयर स्टैंडिंग 30 सेकंड्स लेफ्ट
साले तू खेलना सीख ले मेरे को बोल रहा था स्पैम कर रहा है कब से चार से कर रहा है आ भाई एक किल ज्यादा किया और क्या किया तूने
भाग
तू तो गाना गा रहा है
बैठ चुप
अरे
जा चलो बंद करते हैं
छोड़ दो लोगों को छूती
बंद करते ठीक है
बाय गुड नाइट
बाय 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 बाय
You got me thinking about you way too much But let me simplify, we're out of touch So it might not be enough No, it might not be enough You don't know what I'm waiting for And I don't know how you've been so short It's like you don't even need me anymore Don't need me anymore
I've been trying to find it I'm sorry that it takes so much of my time Yeah, so much of our time Yeah I don't wanna fight it Cause I know deep down that both our paths are aligned Yeah, I know somehow we'll be fine You got me thinking about you way too much But let me simplify, we're out of touch So it might not be enough No, it might not be enough You don't know what I'm waiting for And I don't know how you've been so short It's like you don't even need me anymore Don't need me anymore Not really needing me anymore Don't really understand why you're just leaving me at the door But if you're done, I'm done too Take back every single thing that I gave to you Cause I just don't wanna play for you I guess we're moving on You got me thinking about you way too much But let me simplify, we're out of touch So it might not be enough No, it might not be enough You don't know what I'm waiting for Don't know how you've been so short It's like